reel. We're going to run through this real quick because I've already done three of these and I can't do it again because I'm going to lose my mind. All right, so let's get started. We're going to go over this and what you see on the screen there, which is the Ko-Fi. We'll make it real quick. Physical copy. This includes everything from my shop with the exception of some stuff that came out slightly afterwards, i.e. the Warlock Child subclass. The Child. I don't want to... No, it's not Children Warlocks. Although I'm sure they exist in D&D, but whatever. That's not... No judgment. All right. Whatever. So, first things first. On the Ko-Fi, if you go to ko-fi.com/biscuit10rpg, you'll be able to see the entirety of our page where we store all of our stuff. Not necessarily new, but not well known. I do have membership levels. If you want to support the channel as well as my own personal endeavors, we have two levels, the Aspirant and the Warlock itself, chipping in at a $1 or $5 per month fee. Everything, there are special perks to this. Obviously, you get access to exclusive content, social media shout out when you become one, credit in all my future products that I make, which can take some time, so no worries there. The Warlock tier actually has some extra stuff, specifically exclusive requests. If you want to be one of those folks once a month, if you have something you're like, hey, I'm really struggling with this idea, I want to add something unique into my campaign, you can reach out to me and I will work with you. And we'll come up with something, either a magic item, maybe a monster, maybe an NPC, whatever you want. We'll work together and get you something unique for your campaign. Now, I will tell you this. If we work together, it may end up on the Ko-Fi page itself, but I will not be profiting off of it. It will actually be just marked as free so that your creation that you worked with me to put together will be available to anyone else that chooses to use something fun or funky. And my promise to you all is that will not end up in any of our books. That'll be specifically Ko-Fi exclusive. It won't even make its way over to DriveThruRPG. So, there you go. On my shop, this is the combination of everything I've made so far. Obviously been on a bit of a hiatus for creation-wise here lately because we're working on a super secret project that I cannot tell you about, otherwise Adam will strangle me to death. And I don't need Adam having more stress in his in their life or, you know, my life. I don't want to be strangled. So we got everything here. Melting Pot of Nonsense is 90% of what this is made up of. There, now you can see it. The only difference is it's put in a specific order so that it's easier to read and it's not so chaotic, which is what the Melting Pot of Nonsense was kind of built around, just fun stuff in a weird manner. Also, if you feel the particular need, you want to get the physical copy of this compendium, bam, right here, DriveThruRPG, just look up Biscuit10RPG, all one word, and you can find, oops, I didn't go back after the last take, ignore me. Here we go, The Abyssal Knight, available there for $1.99, just like on Ko-Fi. The only difference is on Ko-Fi I make just a little bit more off of it than I would on DriveThruRPG. However, on DriveThruRPG, guess what? You can leave reviews, so I'll appreciate that too. There's the Compendium of the Absurd right here. And then, of course, I went ahead and threw up the Fae Court Warlocks up there just because it's an interesting concept. Kind of wanted to get it out there. Looks like someone thought 3 out of 5 stars. That's fine. It was a fun one. Didn't put too much stuff into it. But the Compendium itself, as you can see, the PDF plus soft cover is $14.99. Hey, not too shabby. The PDF obviously doesn't have everything that's in the physical copy, as noted right here. The physical copy only has extra edition of the Abyssal Knight version 2, which means that there's two versions of the Abyssal Knight in that particular book, because version 1 relies heavily on paladin oaths and twisting them and perverting them a little bit to give it a little fun flavor. However, the physical copy does have version 2, which is 3 more subclasses specifically for that new core class, as well as 2 more spells that you will not find anywhere else outside of actually purchasing the PDF for the Abyssal Knight by itself. Other than that, I think I've eaten enough time, so we're either going to start here in just a second, and you'll see our friendly, happy, or possibly curmudgeon-y faces pop up in a moment, or you're going to be knocked right back over to that beautiful Biscuit 10 RPG Starting Soon screen. With that, we hope to see you soon, and yeah, definitely check out our stuff. Alrighty. Welcome to Biscuit 10 RPG, everyone. As you know, we had a weird confusion last night. I thought we weren't going to have game today, and I was corrected very kindly by our DM today.
My bad for, scheduling 3 weeks in advance.
And my bad for putting a thumbs up on that without fully reading it.
It's literally like eight words.
All right. So, as you all know, I got the merch up there. I've really got to redo that ad. We got t-shirts, pretty funny ones.
T-shirts.
Fucking adulting, and obviously the logo for Biscuit 10 RPG. If you feel like it, go pick it up from Zazzle. I have all my links and shit, I think, connected to my link tree on Twitter. So just go to @Biscuit10RPG, click on my bio, and you'll find it. Other than that, I don't have anything, so let's get started on the shit show that I've created for all of us with my cowardice.
It can happen for the best of us. So yeah, let's go ahead and jump right back into a Civ Illumination where we will hopefully find our sand swimmers alive and reunited. But let's go ahead and dive back in what happened last week with session 33, beginning with a vision of a mermaid, the lower body of a jellyfish. Ox met his new chance to live and finish what he started, or maybe create something new. Emerging from the ocean and flung onto the main deck of the Ocean Walker, Ox awoke alive and intact, facing a scared and confused George. Returning to Mycerna, Ox was tasked to find clues on the whereabouts of the Emerald Ewer that they gave Yolcates months prior. He needed to find a dwarf, or at least he was guided to find a dwarf with an ugly beard and just as ugly tricorn hat. The rest of the party, curious, seem undeterred with the sudden return of their companion, but they were not out of danger yet to ponder on such semantics. Each took a week to accomplish personal goals, some successful than others, but all ultimately agreed to help Ox get into the good graces of his new powerful entity's task. Locating the dwarf, he revealed the tavern to the members only of the Good Circle Gang, a sort of pirate group that had affiliations with the Freeborn Alliance, a bunch of pirates out in the seas causing a ruckus. Affiliated with the Freeborn Alliance and led to their hideouts. There they searched the area with Sterling, discovering a side entrance of sorts. Entering, they found the missing Vrakati, who had been gone for, was it 2 weeks now? Who had actually been investigating throughout the city during that time. He revealed that the Fire Ganassi woman, the one that Gotalina had crossed paths with when you had first attempted to meet, I believe it was with a thief, the one with the boots. Now I can't remember his name.
Who's who?
No, that was
Steel Toe
before that.
Jacko?
Yeah, there you go. Still
Oh,
talking
yeah.
about.
That, but then later when we met Goblin, it was who's who? It was
Yeah,
fine. Fine. Yeah.
they're friends. Was a member of the Hippus Corps and found out that Gotalina and fought Gotalina, frequented the tavern, and even hired the Good Circle, this very gang, for jobs for the cult. The cult was expanding its reach, and Vrakati also mentioned reports of information gathered by Freeborn spies on the mainland that an odd individual with a magical gem implanted into its head was captured in the town of Kajabo, out towards the center of the continent, and taken by Freeborn pirates to the Dagnia Islands, and that their stronghold, along with a large gang from Apiketla moving to Mycerna, were known to be servants of a Daijini of sorts who have been making moves and taking jobs for the Hippus Corpus Ella as well. The party decided to capture the spymaster and maybe this supposed second command of the Good Circle at the secret tavern for members only. At first, the plan looked promising, the easy capture of the spymaster, but when Ox roared into the main tavern lobby, it proved somewhat disastrous. Outnumbered, the party fought a losing battle to capture a fleeing pirate, with Steven and Sterling falling multiple times and Tav eventually falling to the gang members. Ox fled in search of Gotalina and other comrades to help him save his team. And as we're picking up, it is actually not at night. I messed it up last time. You guys are still in the morning. So you're running early 11 a.m., like mimosa time morning. So people are on the streets in mimosas. And you were like aghast, sweating. Vercati is right behind you. You can see that he is taking this very poorly. He is muttering to himself. You see that his mind is racing. His eyes are darting everywhere. He's a very calculated person from the somewhat times you've noticed him.
Mm-hmm.
You have a decent perception, right?
Yeah. It's still at 15.
Okay, yeah. So you even though he is very elusive, oftentimes you do see him. He is engaging in his own passive way. You now sort of realize that he left to go and do things his own way. He's a lone wolf. That's cool. but you can see that his body is shaking. He's muttering that he has failed, his master Sterling. As you're running, where are you going?
I think the best option is to try to find Godelina. I don't know where she's at, so I'm going to go back to the home first and talk to Jeffrey to see if maybe he knows. I'll ask Riccati.
Yeah.
If do you know where Godelina is? Shit.
You guys both stop at, like, around like a corner street. There's like a couple of dwarves just like pissing out in the morning. Oh, too early to run, boys. Walks back into the tavern. Rakai's just like, you're both are just looking at the guy walk back in. Why is he naked? Anyways, I remember seeing her head over up north to the Radiant Keep, where the soul remains. People that heal people there.
Yeah, the minute he says that keep, I'll recognize the name because we've been in the city enough, and I just start take off running. I'm running awesome. To it.
Sure. As you maneuver through the very sunny day, it is starting to heat up again.
Mm-hmm.
Moving through the crowds, people are. It feels like the people are in your way. Like there just seems to be a pile of people just coming into your path, and you're on. You don't even care at this point. You're honestly just pushing them, moving them aside, even elbowing old people in the face. It doesn't matter because of the haste that is required of you at this moment. Vercati leads the way as well. He's slightly faster than you. And eventually you make it to this sort of rundown rubble piece of area. Most of the place around here is like these little pueblos or sand homes or tenants. So they're like little blocks, and there's multiple homes in these blocks. But there's just this open path with a somewhat half-destroyed wall. It's very simplistic square. The main keep, the main sand building inside this walled estate, just a simple, large brick base. But there are tents above, and there are people up there. You see a small garden. As you burst through the entrance, immediately you see Godelina, who is sort of training outside, what looks like to be a very stout, burly dwarven woman, red hair, very fair, very pale skin. Like she seems like she's from like the Nordlands or like from the northern countries, like from places where snow is. Like she's just everyone's brown here, but yours super super white as paper. but she's wearing heavy thick chainmail, which is surprising because it's fucking hot out here.
Mm-hmm.
And she's wielding a hammer and shield. They're both dueling outside. And you just see that there's people that are sickly, people that are homeless. This place seems to be taking care of these individuals. Vergati's like, right there, over there.
I see it. I just run in, and I will literally dive in the middle of them to stop the combat and just stare directly into Godelina's eyes. Shit.
What?
Shit is, oh my god.
Okay, she already has her sword in her bag and she starts making her way inside the Radiant Keep. The dwarven woman out there, the picture is already in the scribe room, so it is Dame Harav, and she looks, she's like, is there a problem?
Godelina, the Tav and Sterling, failed mission, pirates, help, please. Riccati. Can you please help?
Riccati is just as lost. You see that he's like breaking down under just the massive social circle that's now before him, very influential people that speak very loudly with their ideas and concepts in group meetings are here. So he's very timid, and he sort of backs away. Not to mention, you can see that he's still trying to figure things out in his own head, so he's probably still processing all this.
Okay. I don't know if they're alive.
Totally busts out with all her gear, and she's just like, okay, so what's the situation? Let's start there, and we'll go from there. Where did they take them? Can we still retrieve them?
We came straight from the place where we
hold on, wait, you said they're dead?
I don't know. It looked like that may be the end result. I don't know.
Both of them?
I don't know. It was either I run or I was going to be next.
Let's go. Take me there. Let's go see.
Okay. So I just book it. I'm like,
yeah. As you're running, she's going to ask you. She's like, so why again were you going there? I honestly don't remember.
Effectively trying to stop y'all, Kate.
Right. Okay. Good.
They had information, and that would have led me there. And we made a mistake by engaging the wrong side of a battle, and should have stopped with the spymaster. But I got cocky.
If you guys aren't going to stop me, I'm going to go out there. You know your exact words.
Don't let me make the plans.
Yeah, those are the exact words before it all happened. All right. She's like, okay. Who are these people?
The good sons. Is that what they are?
Oh, the good circles, gangs, pirates. Yep. Okay, they're affiliated with Nicerelia.
They're all kind of connected, interconnected. Like, there's apparently ties between them, between Nicerelia and possibly the cult as well.
She turns back and gives you this deadly look. She's just like, okay, this is fucking serious. If that's the case, you see that she speeds up. She says, and you can see that she's getting a little frustrated. She's like, everything is getting consumed and tainted by them.
As we're running, I just look at him like, I could use some help. It's like I'm at half health.
I got you. She turns like, oh, I'm sorry. All this is coming all at once, and I'm very frustrated.
It's fair. I've got to redeem myself. I'm going to murder the shit out of somebody. I mean, avenge the shit out of somebody.
Well, before we get to that, we need to take care of both Tav and Sterling, make sure they're okay. So she's going to go ahead and do some healies. I think for right now, no, I'll just go ahead and just heal you.
I'm at 37 out of 67.
That's fine. I'm gonna try to heal you as best like as much as I can.
Okay.
So no, we're not gonna go with that. Wow. I can't. Oh. So you're gonna gain back 24.
Cool.
All right. She's going to cast Clear Wounds. She's going to go above a couple levels. She just sort of like... Well, her healing magic is sort of aggressive. Like, she has to like yell at you and point these very noticeable glyphs. So people are just like... What the heck? She's like, on Monfera, this massive golden glyph appears. And it just sort of covers up, like it splits apart and covers up wounds all over you, trying to heal him up. And so like under the current circumstances, as you're running through these still now growing busier city in the morning, people are just like, what the heck is going on? Oh, healing. She's a priestess. And people are just like, hey. priestess.
So just for the flavor and so that she'll probably notice, I don't have my weapon on me at all. But as we get closer to the building, I will use one of my actions to summon it so that I'm ready for the combat rather than walking in unarmed.
All right. So making your way back around noontime. As you scope out the Scorpion's Way, as you make your way backtracking it, you actually even go near the docks to remember the path that you took there, because it is nestled very, very, you can get lost in that area behind the Artisan's Guild Hall with all those slums back there. And as you pass the Artisan Guild Hall, you find Laguna walking out, like tossing a little bag of coins.
I literally point at Laguna. Come on! There's murder to be had! I know how to get his attention.
You see him just like jog right next to go to Lena, and going, Lena's just like. Just give a long sigh. Laguna looks really tired. You see that he has like a large black like bag in his eyes. He's like, so who are killing?
Pirates.
Lame.
They're connected with everybody, including the cult. Just like as we're running, I'm like, I'm just kind of explaining everything that's going on so he gets more excited.
Yeah, as you're saying that, when you bring up the cult, because he's been getting more interested in the cult, he's like, oh, worthy challengers. Maybe these are the ones that can sate my thirst to kill people. So he's like, all right, interesting. I will do this. Blood will be spilled. And Gardner's like, no, we're not just going to be spilling blood. We need to save Sterling and Tab. And Lagoon's just like, oh, they both fell?
I also point out, like, if you see this particular person or this particular person, we need them alive. At least okay, one of them.
Are you pointing out? Are you pointing at the spymaster?
Yeah, the spymaster and the second in command. Yeah.
Okay, the one you better you killed.
Yeah.
Were you the one who killed the bear? No, it was Tav who killed the bear.
Yeah, Tav cared. Tav was killed the bear. Oh,
yeah.
Tav's definitely dying now.
Yeah, we're killing that one.
All right. So when you get there, you can see that there are only a couple of thugs. Well, there are now a couple of thugs. Back then it was hidden, so there were no guards out, so no one would go there. But now there are a couple of thugs out. You see that they have what looks like to be barrels, and they start pouring them onto large sort of stacks of little twigs, little burning ember twigs or whatever. Mm-hmm. And they're just throwing all around the building, and you can definitely tell, like, oh, they're trying to burn this whole place now.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a couple of them, and as you make your way, you guys, into the alleyway, before you is this open area that leads into the sort of front of the building. There is the side bench area, so you can go there too, but there's a couple guards outside. They don't seem to notice you yet, so the rest of your party stop us alleyway looking at go, and he's like, all right, so, as she looks at all of you, she's like, are we just gonna go kill these poor, or are we going to interrogate them, talk to them first?
It
looks like they're gonna burn down the entire building, so
keep one of them, keep one of them, and okay. Stop the fire.
Well, Ox, your time to redeem yourself. Go ahead.
I summon my sword from nowhere.
What does it look like when you summon your pack weapon?
I've kind of elevated this a little bit. It will actually shoot from my hand in a splash of water and see just a deep green with, to base it a little bit more off the patron, it looks like jellyfish tendrils.
Ooh, that's what I wanted to hear.
Whoosh! And as it shoots out, I reach up and grab it, and then I'm literally, I go, so there are two separate entrances. Okay.
Yes.
I point to Laguna, and I point to those two, and I just give the both of those guys are dead. Like, look, like the hand across the throat, just they're dead. And then stop the fire. And then I just point at Godelin and go, whichever one you want, you may be able to help keep one of them alive, because if not, this is going to go bad. And I immediately start, I'm going to try to sneak up as quick, best as I can, so that I can catch at least one of them completely off guard, so that I can just end that guy quickly.
Yeah. Go ahead and make a stealth check for me.
All right. Skills, stealth check. Watch me totally fuck this one up. All right. 10.
That's what you needed. Because they are literally oblivious to this. Because they're just, all right, fire time. And so you sneak up on one of them. Gonalina is right behind you. You both get the jump. What do you do to this poor guy?
So this guy, since I got the jump on him, I'm gonna knock him out. But as he's passing, like what I want to do is I'm gonna choke him out, like I did the what's his face, the spy master. And as he's like slowly going into darkness, I'm just gonna say, arson is a crime.
Who are you? You're a mad murderer, but you're also like, I'm also a DARE officer. All right. Yeah, as you slowly put him to a sleeper hold, and he's like, falls asleep. You see the other guy gets knocked on his back, and he's like, oh, who are you? And then Golan is just like, boom, right down, breaks his jaw. He's knocked out. And she's like, all right, that was easy. And then who's going to third guy? Oh, Laguna.
Laguna had the other so one as you or
both
two.
As you both look at each other, you hear as his axe just goes right through the guy's side. He just throws him 5 feet, drops the bundle of sticks and barrels of oil, you assume. Laguna's just like, pirates, man. Lame. Just absolutely no contest. And he just casually walks up, grabs his axe.
So any of the fire that may have already been started, I'm just trying to kick sand over it.
No, they haven't started yet. Okay, they were literally just prepping still. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I'm going to try to kick it away from the building, so in case someone else is watching, they can't just start the building on fire when we walk in.
For sure, after. I will say that there is quite a bit of oil on the walls and stuff.
Yep. So I'm just going to, like, cover it in sand.
All right.
Anything.
You half-assed it because you were like, wait, what am I doing?
Yeah, what the fuck? Shit.
Okay, all right. So you make your way back inside. Mm-hmm. You don't remember everything inside the building, but you now sort of see that it's a little bit less. So they might have taken a lot of stuff with them. It has been about 30 minutes, mm-hmm. But they can't have gone far. But the one thing that you notice is Gotolina is already right next to the corpse of Sterling. Riccati walks slowly to the corpse as well. And Laguna's just like, it's sort of weird because normally when he's just sitting there, he's actually looking at you, but he's not looking at you this time.
There is a rage forward. Building up inside of me as I see Sterling's dead body. I was like, nobody kills him but me!
Bernalina goes ahead and picks up Sterling's body. She's just like, ah. All right. Riccati has already been searching the entire rest of the compound. And he returns to this. There's no secret entrances, no other ones at least that I can know of. Tav and Steven are gone.
I hand him like a bag of 100 gold and I just say, please get the Thieves Guild to locate them as quickly as possible.
Jordan Lee's just like, well, we have those two outside. Let's first interrogate them before we spend any money. Let's be reasonable here.
two birds, one. I'm gonna. All right. I walk upstairs and I grab like one of them. Actually, I grab them both and I just drag them down the stairs and throw them right next to the bar.
Okay. Loud cracks from both of them. Probably both their noses broken. Mm-hmm. They both turn around just like, what do you want, man?
Where are they?
Go ahead and make an intimidation check.
Just fair.
Go ahead and make it with advantage.
All right.
They are pretty solid dudes, but there's a lot of destruction in front of them.
Jesus, I rolled shit on both of them. 8.
8.
No.
With advantage?
Yeah, with advantage. I rolled a 1 and a 3.
So, in your fury, you actually kill one of them.
Okay.
Because you notice that the first time your first tactic doesn't seem to get their effect, and because you're so enraged, mm-hmm. you let out for a little bit. I shouldn't say he's not, he's dead. I'm saying that he's like dying. Mm-hmm. Okay. So he's out there just bleeding out. And the other guy, now he is like, okay, well, this guy's off the handle, and he looks to the others. Laguna's just like looks away. Gonalina just literally simply shakes her head.
don't mess with him.
Riccati puts up his mask. Is anyone else with you? No, I think that's it.
No, just so, yeah. Just everyone going, he's unhinged. You might want to answer.
Yeah. Yeah. So applying to that same, like amplifying your intimidation as you're just like hunched over, giving probably the most vile, just furious look of like, I can tear your soul into pieces right now, and there's nothing you can do about it. And he's now slightly scared. So he says, and it's a big, like, burly dwarf. He's like, okay, I'll talk. They probably took them to either our ship, the Wind Charm, which probably unlikely. It's out at sea right now. So they're probably at the Gold Oasis Casino. So that's where our big racket is, where our boss is.
Perfect. So,
yeah, good luck.
And I knock him out.
Yes, the bar. All right. All right, go to Leech. It's like, all right, well, we don't know if she's alive or dead, but if they did take her, we can assume she's alive. So
I look for Steven's body.
There is no body of Steven.
Okay.
Verratti says that Steven and Tab were not.
Okay, fine. Okay.
Yeah. So it seems that both of them were taken. If Steven was not here, we would, you know, that means that Steven's definitely alive.
Yeah.
Very easy to assume that Steven's definitely alive. If, maybe. Well, we'll see. Just kidding. All right. So with that, Golden says, all right, well, she sort of like pats like Sterling's head. She's like, we can resurrect Sterling. I will use most of mine, probably all of my savings, to resurrect him.
I was gonna offer money because I have some.
That's okay. That's fine. I have it all in gold, and Kamos would prefer it in gold. So we're going to head back to the Radiant Keep. Kamos will perform the ritual. It will take a couple hours because Kamos, unfortunately, though a high priest of Pelor, is also very eccentric and likes to be, what's the more word, traditionalist. He loves processions or things happening in certain, it's annoying. So she starts walking out.
I just look at her. I'm like, any way I can make it go faster.
Unfortunately, because he is powerful enough to do such a feat, I would allow him to do what he needs to do to do his thing. It's a process for priests. I'm not one of them. I just fight for them.
Okay. I look at Riccati and I'm like, all right, and I hand him the gold now and say, get them on it to keep an eye on it and make sure that they're paying attention and seeing if they can find out where they are in the building so that maybe we don't have a repeat of what happened this last time.
Roddy nods his head. He understands. He's going to take the gold. And he says, he looks at all of you and he says, we should probably also just take into account that if Good Circle is also working with the Hibis Corpse, we should move Jeffrey somewhere safer.
And I'll take care of that.
Well, he looks at Golding. He's like, we should keep Jeffrey will be safe for a while until we find a more suitable place. I was going to suggest your ship's Ox, but they left yesterday, right?
Yes. They're off making a delivery.
A 19-day delivery.
Mm-hmm.
Correct. So we're going to have to figure that out. But right now, I would offer the Radiant Keep unless you have another place in mind, Ox.
Nothing. I was just going to try to make sure that everyone that's there has their eyes peeled a little bit better, knowing what we know now.
Well, I mean, Rakai's just like, well, I mean, with the shirt, it's easy to assume now that the churches are easily swayed and influenced by them. So, and they've been watching the house in large numbers. I don't know if you probably have noticed by now.
Yep.
Probably best that we move away from there for the time being. I don't see any other safe place that's being offered. Probably at least, it's up to you. You and Kamal also. Oh wait, Kamal's with the tree. Mm-hmm. With the crew. Yeah. Okay, never mind. I mean, yeah, do you want to just leave Jeffrey there with some people in?
Yeah, I just want to make sure that they're more prepared and ready for anything.
Alright, so you also want to like, okay, that's fine. Do you want to like hire some thieves or some people over there to like just be security or?
Yeah. 100
gold is a lot of money. Like, you can do a lot of things with 100 gold with these guys. Like, you can like, name your...
Yeah, name I want some muscle there to keep an eye on and maybe distract the Shirtas to something else and just have them have their attentions too split to actually focus solely on that house.
Okay. All right, okay. Riccati, not decided, says, we'll be back. He's going to try to get back as fast as he can so he can see Sterling again.
I'm going to... I'm going to be waiting. I have no patience for this long ass thing. So I'm literally just going to go back to the house and at the very least take a short rest.
That's fine. So Godelina, says okay. And she makes her way. And then Laguna will go back with you.
Yep.
Because Laguna doesn't know where to fuck. Laguna's probably not welcome there. after a couple of hours, or sorry, if you want to talk to Laguna at your house, feel free to now.
So I'm going to tell Laguna about my plan with that fight club, assuming we survive.
Laguna looks at me, he's just like, I have to take the fall.
You just take the fall once, give it a couple weeks, and then you can take it back over. And we split the pot. 50-50.
Okay. I'll agree if I take it back from you again, right?
Yeah, that's it.
Okay. Just a rematch. All right. Mm-hmm. Also
25%. 25%.
25%. Oh. Oh, okay. I'll just take the money then. Okay, cool. Never mind then.
No, I was asking as in what do you mean? So you get 25%? Sounds good. I just look him dead in the eyes.
Okay, yeah, for sure.
Okay. Like, wait a minute. All right, so I get 75%, you get 25%. Sounds good. And I start walking back towards the I don't meditate or anything, so I'm just kind of relaxing, trying to restore myself because what we're about to do is going to be batshit crazy again. I feel like we might have Laguna with us this time, so who knows how that's gonna go.
Sterling, whatever concept you have of an afterlife for your people, it's never really been, well, at least based on the majority of the faith of at least the congregated Warforged in Cyber Sanctum. Much of them believe in primates or of mechanists. Believe that all things come in order and all things come to an end. Everything has a process. Everything has a reason. Has a purpose. Obviously, for you, you're a little bit of different sorts, and you're not the only one. Some people have called you rogue, roguish, but to you, you've learned that maybe that's just your nature, and maybe that you're starting to learn a little bit more about the true psyche of Warforged. But semantics aside. Describe to me what would be something that Sterling would see if he were to enter a afterlife, making his way to the realm of where his soul would reside. At least if you had a notion or idea.
I mean, if you're going to like whatever form of hell that primates have, I don't.
Well, I do run sort of a cosmology, so he would go to some sort of realm where some sort of powerful entity, doesn't even have to be a god. Definitely, if Mechanicus is not your favorite, which understandable, you're definitely rogue. Name a place where you think he would go. It could be anyone. You don't know all the deities in my world, that's fine, but name a place. Name somewhere. So you want to go to Nine Hells, or do you want to go to Yes? Is that where you think Sterling's soul would make his way?
I guess.
He's knocking out mechanisms. Hey, I'm not that bad.
Come on. He definitely deserves to go there, but
I don't think anyone really cares. Like, I don't think it's all about deserving a mechanism. It's just about work, do this, listen. Take orders.
I'm not sure. I haven't thought about it too much, I guess.
That's perfect. That's perfectly fine. And because of that, it's actually a great choice, regardless. So you don't know if you're seeing things, you don't even know what you'll have. You remember that your vision begins to fade to this gray and dark sort of tint, and eventually turns to complete blackness. There's no more senses, there's no directive, there's no thought, but there is some sort of sensory awareness. Vaguely, you see, imaginatively, your eyes open somewhat, but you can vaguely see through the blackness, what looks like to be this very silvery, starry night sky. Large orbs of different colors and textures and patterns float certain distances around you as you just seamlessly are pulled or carried by invisible wave force. You see large craters, it's not craters, asteroids floating, but they become bigger and bigger as you continue your way wherever you're going, and you notice that these are huge husks, corpses of massive entities, long dead, forgotten, gone. There's a bright light on the other side, sort of where you're going, but it seems to be illuminating certain areas of this darkness, this starry night that you're passing through. You can even maybe glimpse what looks like to be sailing ships with silvery sails, sort of drifting on these little waves of silver sand in this night sky. And suddenly you feel this tug, and it becomes dark. And in that darkness, a warmth is finally felt. Now the sensory of feeling, touch, and then you hear vague, vague distant echoes of trumpets and angelical choirs being rung in the distance, and the light gets brighter and brighter, and suddenly you wake in this stone marble sort of room. There are censers and incenses lit and smoky everywhere, candelabras, a lot of gold, a lot of white. Standing before you is a Tiri Godelina, a Tiri Vercati, a bawling Ghassan, and a hiding his tears, Orestes. Not Orestes. Orestes stayed back with Jeffrey. Just because he was too overwhelmed with the news. What else is there? I think that's it. There are also two other different people there. There is a very pale, sort of ginger-like dwarven woman, curly red hair, long red hair. She's wearing like a chain helm and then chainmail, heavy chainmail and scale plating. And she has white robes over top of them with the large golden sun of Pelor on the as the heraldry. She has a hammer and shield on her back. And then there's this gaunt brown or tan-skinned man with long, droopy sort of jet black hair, a very large nose with several nose piercings, a lot of them with gold and diamonds sort of hanging from the tips. You see that his eyes are white. His large cracked hands are over you as some sort of fading white magical strings that were probably connected to your body begins to slowly rise back and sink into his flesh. His eyes close and he reopens with silvery eyes and looks down and he looks at Godelina and says, "The resurrection complete." He sits down. He says, "Tea, oh great." He sits down and waits for servants to bring him tea. And Sterling, you are awake. You are naked, Warforged. You were pilfered of everything besides your muskets and whatever is remaining in your character inventory. Everything else, including your money, has been pilfered. But you are awake and alive, Sterling. Godelina immediately jumps and hugs you and looks at your Warforged eyes and like sort of pokes and she's like, "Yep, you're still, you're in there."
Did I die?
I honestly don't know if you could die. I don't know if you were just going to be off for a long time.
I think I might have. I feel like, did someone revive me? I don't.
Yes, Sterling, we are in a place called Radiant Keep. The guild members here are servants of Pelor, healers. I was fortunate enough to ask of my friend here, High Priest Kamu, to return you back to the living. We didn't think at first it was possible. We don't know much about the Warforged, but it seemed that it worked. You have a soul, which is even better news, for my faith at least. I can trust you fully.
didn't trust me fully before.
We'll talk about that another time.
Oh, holy shit, that's so backhanded. That's amazing.
She gives you all your, like, I'm sorry about all your other great scenes of the good circle took the rest. Ox is waiting back at home, obviously trying to contain his anger and frustration. But we should head back. I would like to hear from you, since you have a more calmer mind, Sterling, right now. What happened? Why? What exactly will you do? I vaguely know that Ox said about, you know, him his returning, which I'm still trying to get over with. I was discussing with Tomo here about what. Obviously, I thought it was a true resurrection of some sort. That have to have been something very powerful to have brought Ox back from the brink, or from nothing, really. But anyways, from your expertise, as you're like putting whatever remnant gear, the dwarven woman actually walks out, and you see that she brings in some equipment. She says, "Looks like you're gonna be needing some of these if you're gonna be causing mayhem out there." And she sort of side eyes Gordolina and goes like, "Look, I'm trying my best, okay? I'm not the goody good two shoes you knew when I was a child, okay?" She will go ahead and give you Sterling, she sees you as a musket, but she still offers you a light crossbow with 20 bolts if you choose to want to take it. She gives you leather armor, studded leather armor, and then two daggers and a short sword.
Yeah, I'll definitely take those. Right. I only have 5 bullets, so.
Now, Sterling, you were just returned through the resurrection spell, so you are at a -4. And I think you're at, -4 exhaustion, or I can't remember what it was.
I think it's a -4 to skill checks.
The skill checks, okay. And then every long rest deducts 1 from that. However, Kamu also comes up to you, and you see that he has this beautiful golden elephant sort of tea kettle. He opens and you see that there's like, it looks like mercury water, like mercury, like liquefied mercury is it, but it smells like lavenders. He says, "This is a restorative water. It will cleanse you and cleanse you of evil spirits and diseases and stuff. It will also restore your vitality, especially from a powerful spell that has brought you back from," as he looks at you, says, "from probably a very far away place." And he pours you a cup, a golden cup of this restorative potion.
I guess Sterling at this point is no position to refuse it. Drinks it.
Yeah, if you want to take that -4 for the rest of the session.
The reason not to.
All right, so as you drink it, this is the first time, maybe one of the first times you try to consume things because you don't need food. You do have a mouth mechanic, which is odd, but then again, you were constructed by humanoids in the likeness of them. So they gave you jaws and stuff for no reason. It can open a little bit, but you just pour it down and it does seep into the inside of your chassis. Your body. You're not a car.
I'm a car now.
You're not a vehicle. And you can feel parts of your natural, like, wooden fibers and natural materials that have been infused with magic. And you can feel this, you can actually feel this glow, and your body sort of glows somewhat. And yep, you don't have that -4 anymore, so you're just normal. It's like you having a long rest.
Oh, so are you telling
HP? Huh?
Well, yeah, pretty much, Tox.
Yeah, so you're telling me that he just drank like a combination of metal and wood varnish?
Nice. And it made him feel better.
Wow, I feel great.
So you are shiny, you smell great, and you're ready for the next Pine Car Derby rally. That if they ran in the desert, I don't think they would. They'd probably be not the correct setting for pine car racing.
we gotta get him some wheels.
Yeah, that's him. All right. All right. So with that, if you already didn't add that, you can go ahead and add the equipment that the Dame Harav has given you, Sterling. So that's studded leather armor, a light crossbow with 20 bolts, if you want the light crossbow with 20 bolts, it's up to you. But at least two daggers and a short sword. You hear Kalmo's like, all right, Godelina, 3,000 gold pieces, as promised, right? And Godelina's just like, of course, she hands him a large velvet sack. She's like, this will do a lot of good for the city. And he gives it to one of the priests who takes it. And Godelina's like, I know. I was eventually going to give it over, but I wanted to buy something for you all first. She's like, no need. Bringing back one life with good, noble causes is enough for me. So, with that, you probably return. So Verkadi is there. He apologized to you, Sterling. This is the first time he's been more vocal to you. He says, I'm sorry, Sterling. I'm not so sorry. I work a lot better on my own. I know I shouldn't be working on my own, but I could accomplish more if I could find more information for everybody, since we don't have that.
It's fine. Just next time, maybe leave a note or something.
I will.
Thought you might have been like in danger.
I could have been, and that's on me as well. Gasaz, he's a big crybaby. So that's all he's doing right now. He tries to hug you, but he's awkward about it. He's never hugged you before. So, however you want to deal with that.
Very like stiff hug back.
The wording was priceless. However you want to deal with that.
He starts crying even louder. So Godelina sort of understands the situation. Says, apparently, Ox hired some thieves to look out the area, and Fry was like, I've already sort of scoped out the area. Isn't your contact Brave Whisper over there? She's like, oh. Well, I don't think, I don't know if he's still there. He hasn't contacted me over a week. I've been to all of my meeting spots with him in the past week, but he's never arrived, and that's not like him. He's pretty punctual with his time. Right now, with all this going on, with all of this, gangs being related and being influenced by the Hippus Corps, which is an even far more dangerous endeavor than I anticipated. I can't trust anybody that I don't talk to on a daily basis. So, right now I can't worry about Brave Whisper, but thieves are being hired to look her. That's perfectly fine. Verkai tells you all that there's two entrances that he's found. He's pretty good at finding things. I mean, he appeared out of nowhere in the Scorpion's way, so looks like he's pretty decent at it. Obviously, there's two entrances, front and a back. Both have the same amount of guards. It is a two-story building with three floors, technically. The main lobby, he says, is all the gambling casino, the gambling den itself, with a little couple mini bars there. And then there's a spiral staircase on the opposite side that leads to the upper floors. He doesn't know there's a basement. There is some access points on the roofs. And Ox, as you're the party's hearing this for Akadi, you get these thieves that knock on your door and they're telling you the exact same thing. As you're just like, all right, yeah, come on. What else?
come on, anything. Okay, fine, whatever.
And so as the thieves tell you pretty much the same information, and they go. You notice that there's a lot of weird, very well, they're inconspicuous, but you yourself know, that guy looks like a murderer. He's hiding near my trash bin, but I know he's a hired sword. Still a little bit sketched out. it's like you go to to your nearby prison to hire a security guard for a party, and you're like, yeah, those guys look so sketchy. Why are they my guards?
It's fine. At this point, it's better than what I've been dealing with.
Yeah, which you notice that there aren't a lot of Sherdos around. You did see a Sherda get pushed by a couple thugs and he got arrested. But another thug took his place. So they got some fall guys. All right, cool.
Sweet. The Shredder's like, what the fuck? He's like,
so
shut
now
up, bitch.
Your home is now a gang hideout.
Perfect.
All right, so you make your way in, go to, you actually see Gotolina turn a tree, and she's like, as the group makes the way, you see Sterling, and Sterling is wearing different armor. He looks like he's not wearing his gear, which makes sense. But you see that he has his musket at least. But yeah, Sterling is alive and well, Ox, as you pull all you out of the door.
I just walk over to him, just pat him on the back. Man, if anybody's going to accidentally kill you, it's not going to be bad guys. It's going to be me. And I just start walking next to him.
Oh, God.
Why? God, dude.
The chaos energy is strong. Very mixed vibes from this party. First building, says he didn't fully trust me, and Ox says he's going to accidentally kill me.
The chaos is strong in this party.
Yes, chaos is growing. Chaos rising. All right. That should be your new arc name. Sandstormers, we became Chaos Rising for about, you know, an arc, and then we returned to become Sandstormers again because chaos is too much. We caused too much mayhem. All right. So with that, you all know what's the game plan. So what are you guys doing? You guys are back inside the house. Jefferson's like, what is going on? Why are there so many thugs outside our home?
Oh, it's just
cops,
keep you safe.
Well, at least they're, you know, as you see one thug like walk in, he's just like rolling a gold leaf. He's like, all right. Like, well, at least they got stuff. You guys, they're just sitting on the couch sparking one up.
I walk over to the wine, I grab one and hand it to the thug.
I'm just like, nice.
This is getting out of control.
On tap? And Jeffrey's just like, yep. Totally. It's just Golden is the last to close the door, and she's just like, what is this, a frat house?
Apparently.
I'm gonna walk up to my room and I'm just gonna close it and lock the door.
That's gonna help.
Alright, so down here, so we look around, Golden looks at you, Sterling, she's like, alright, so what's your take on this, Sterling?
Well,
if Tav is at the Gold Oasis Kia, which is a large, somewhat large building, it's right next to the August Mansions, right next to the military, the military fortress. We need to be careful at this, for the most part. In and out, honestly, we can't get bogged in there killing people. And yeah. One, I'm not going to be part of that, anyways. I'm going to go find Tav. But yeah, what's your take?
I think Tav is in there. I think the best route is, since we can go through the roof, we take that, and then we go down into probably where she is probably some basement they have, and we avoid the main area completely, just to avoid anyone seeing us or making a commotion. And then I think as far as we get down there, as we can, we need to try to keep our heads low. I don't think we should try to engage in too much combat right now, at least.
Ox is making a visibly hurt face because no one asked him what his thoughts were.
Well, last time we asked what your thoughts were, I got killed, so let's...
You still upstairs, Ox?
No, I literally went up, locked the room, and came back downstairs.
Okay. Oh, yeah, she looks at you like, all right, Ox, what about you?
All right, so I agree with not making a big commotion. We should sneak in. We should free Tav and Steven. And I think, if possible, if we can find one, we should take the Spymaster or somebody else influential to try to gain information. We don't have to kill everybody, as much as I would really like to, you know, avenge Sterling. That's a half-truth.
Of the same mind as well, I feel you.
Because it'll help us figure out what's going on with the ties between the organizations and get me that much closer to freeing y'all Kates of the Ewer.
I haven't thought about it that much yet, but is that really a good idea? Who are you giving this Ewer to?
I don't know how it works with my patrons, so I just think, like, really hard, what's your name?
if you're drinking wine, you see a sort of like gelatinous sort of eye appear, and it's closed and then it opens. And she tells you, I am Zaklar.
Zaklar.
And mouth appears and the eye disappears.
Okay, and I am going to, what do I roll to see if I know about anything about that?
Go ahead and make a religion check or a history check.
All right, those are probably both the same, but I'll check. Let me see here. They're both intelligence-based, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
But I'll also take wisdom for you as well.
Okay.
If you want to use that.
Yeah, I think that one actually, yeah, I at least have a plus one in wisdom, so I'm just going to roll wisdom.
This is based on stories you heard from Dagny. That's one.
Two.
Truly made a deal with a god you know nothing about.
There's one story you heard about, an outrageous one. This is when Dagny was one in her drunken stupors, where she's like, I'm gonna go and try to foresee the future today, and then she just gets drunk that day. Does a lot of peyote and stuff. On her wild tangent, she comes to you while you're like, I don't know, helping make dinner or whatever. After lunch, she like grabs you. He's like, there's a force to be reckoned with underneath the stand. Very rigorous. So you basically describe to her this erratic whatever Dagny told you, and that's probably not right at all. But I will say that based on what you sort of saw from her, you sort of think that this creature, one, is definitely old, but is probably, you can best speculate that it is something created by like older beings, not necessarily gods, but maybe older beings.
Okay, so I'll just be like, I will keep 90% of that crazy ass story to myself and just tell.
It's like Rick Sanchez, like, Morty, we're gonna be together, Morty. That's exactly what Dagny did.
we're gonna be together, Morty. We're gonna go save the world, Morty.
That was Dagny when she did that to you.
And I'm just like, okay. So I'm just like, so it's I'm gonna act like confident, like with the name and what I know, and just say the name. Zaklar? Zaklar?
Zaklarina is going to go ahead and make a... She's going to go with history check, and she's going to also use wisdom. And that's going to be based on really biased history books that she's read from from the angels. So she has plus three. Yeah. Nine. She has a little sheep. He thinks that when she says Zaklar, she's like, Zaklar, where have I heard that name before? She can't remember, so she doesn't know either. But she feels like she knows of it. But anyway, she's like, okay. Don't like it still, but it's better than Narsarelia, I guess. At least for the time being. I guess we'll get to that another time. All right, so are we ready to go then?
Yeah. As we're walking, I'm just gonna regale. Because at this point, I'm so traumatized that I'm jaded. I'm just gonna go ahead and talk to her about what it's like to be eaten by sharks.
Bodolina looks at me and says, "I've been meaning to ask. Yeah, Vanox. First of all, please stop explaining to me how you keep seeing Chum and also yourself at the same time. What happened? Did you call out to help? Did you?
Nope. Did you I was just a floating sink? Head. Well, a sinking head. Head sink, yeah. By the way.
Band name.
Head sink. No, so I just the darkness reached out, and there was a light, and it was a mer-jelly creature.
Mer-jelly creature helped you, brought you back.
Yeah, brought me back and said that, I didn't really have a choice. And then I want you to stop Nicerelia and not so many words, and take the ewer away and deliver it unto me. And then she said that she would help me get back to where I belong, which is pretty dope.
As you guys are making your way, Godelina sort of stops, and she stops you for a second, like puts her hand on. You briefly stop. She's like, "What?" And she immediately is gonna divine sense you. So you see these two triangles of light, made of like light, little magical glyphs appear in front of her eyes, and they flicker with bright luminous fire, and then she eventually fades in a moment. And then you guys continue running. She says, "Interesting. I don't know if you realize this, Ox, but you have an aura around you that reeks. And I don't mean that in a harsh way. I mean, it's just very, profound. It permeates around you now that I've sort of sensed.
As she says that, I just sniff my armpit. Like, did I forget to
shower? No, you smell just as bad. You smell normal just as bad. It's more like, how should I put it? You're covered in some sort of elemental aura. It's a mixture of the elemental plane of water with elemental plane of earth at the same time, along with something darker, something more sinister. I might have to contemplate my books on this when we've retrieved Tav and Stephen."
Okay. Just nonchalantly, okay.
By the way, you do now know how to speak two new languages.
Yep, the Aquan and something else.
Yeah, so when you're passing by, and this has been very minute, but when she brings that up, it does now become more profound. As you're passing by people, trying to get through crowds, making your way all the way on the other side of the city to get to the Gold Oasis Casino, there are like some fish in nearby water, like people, creature waters and tanks. There's even fish like in stalls and stuff like that. You can somewhat vaguely hear whispers permeate from all these creatures of water, like creatures that have traditionally been, or lineages of water, specifically fish, and stuff like that. You even find that some of them, like smaller, more microscopic entities and puddles of water and other liquid sources, you can also faintly feel and hear, which is very sensory overload, I guess you could say, as you're now even more aware of this. Yeah, it's something to get used to. All right.
Become Aquaman.
Hey, you can talk to sharks.
I can.
That's cool. You can't bring sharks on land with you, or you can, but you don't want to.
Get your ass over here. I can't swim. I don't care.
You have to fight in the water. All right. So with that, you guys are making your way to Tav.
Yes.
Tav, you awake slowly. Eyes. Oh, it is vaguely bright. And it's only because that you're in a dark room and there's a small slit on one side of the four sides in this room. And it's exposing that beam of light. You awake to distant echoes of Stephen yelling for help and farther echoes of Lloyd trying to wake you up. Wake up, Tav. Tav, wake up, please.
Yeah, I'm awake.
But as you're waking through the grogginess, like you've been sleeping for days, you know, those echoes now, you now know that those aren't real. Those are just something probably from your subconscious as you're awake. You feel around because it's dark inside. You have dark vision, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. You look around, you can see in the grayness that you are, all you're wearing is your normal tunic, and everything's gone, including your ring. However, you can summon your ring again.
Yeah.
And your rapier.
Yeah.
So you find yourself in a 6x6 stone room with a small 8-inch by 4-inch opening on one side of the wall that you can easily hear and smell outside. You can hear the seagulls, the ocean waters crashing outside. You are near the coast. You're near the beach. somewhere. Unfortunately, well, you're 6x6. How tall are you?
What are the 5'11"?
5'11". You can actually sort of glimpse over. You can see that there's a beach. There's some buildings down there. There are some other landmarks that may be pretty interesting. Go ahead and make a either intelligence or wisdom check. It doesn't matter.
So 9.
9. Yeah, you don't know where you're at from this location. All right. So okay, yeah, you cannot barely make out. Well, you can make out that you do see a end tower of the city, of a city wall, and it's definitely the city walls of Myserna that you're currently in. So you're still in Myserna. It's facing north. Because of that, if it's facing north, that means you're probably on the south side of the city. And you have been here in the city for quite some time now. So you know that if that's the case, you're by this beach. This is the closest beach to this end of the city walls. That would be near Fort Abige and the Gold Oasis Casino, along with the Aga's Mansion. So you're way farther than where you were originally. Judging by the height of where you're looking and where, you know, the size of the city and buildings near you and in the distance, you're probably 50 to 60 feet high up in the air. Probably some sort of tall building of sorts. But yeah. You are in this dry, stone, dark room.
Okay, so probably not teleport out of here. That's not a great idea. Okay. I can hear Steven.
No, those are like your subconscious. Oh. So right now it is relatively quiet.
Yeah. Fucking subconscious. I want to see my boy. Well, is there a door somewhere?
A door? Sure, let's go to the map then.
A map?
Yeah.
Ooh. Ah. Well.
So you're in the top room.
That's a big door.
A big door.
Okay.
Big iron door.
Yeah, so I only have my ring and my sword. I don't have any of my other equipment.
Nope. Everything is gone.
Okay. So I'm gonna... Should I do that or should I wait? Fuck it. I'm gonna misty step outside the door.
Outside the door, okay. Give me a second.
Did I have a short rest or?
No, you did not.
Okay, yeah. So this is great. This is fine. Probably should have healed myself before.
Are you going full 30?
No, just right outside the door.
Okay.
I don't end up in a wall or something.
That's why I was that. No, kidding. No, you're good. Bing, bing, boom. Boom. Two thugs who looks like they're walking away from your door turn around. They hear you and see. Oh, shit. All right. She didn't scream. She teleported out doors.
Oh, fuck.
All right. Go ahead and roll initiative.
Oh, fuck. Oh, 10. I should have healed before I jumped out. Why didn't I think about that? God damn it.
I've been there, man.
I'm thinking, okay, let's get out of here. Oh, I have 1 HP. Oh, fuck, no.
All right. You roll a 10, you said?
Yeah.
All right. Let me roll.
Oh, thank God.
What?
Oh, not 20. No, I thought you said a 1.
No, I rolled a 19 plus 1.
Oh, God, no.
Well, this is happening.
I guess so.
I don't have that
here. I thought you were going to plan some stuff out. Interesting. Let's just bamf out at 1 HP. Oh, fuck. Descending order.
I don't think so far ahead. Who do you think I am?
That's true. All right, so he's gonna go ahead like, oi. And you hear a familiar, actually, you've never heard his voice. So you hear another voice. You hear the voice of like a very like a lizard folk type person. He's like, what do you mean? The demon woman's escaped. Teleport out the door. She has weapons. It's like, that's impossible. So he's talking. So he's going to go ahead. This guy's going to go ahead and pull out his hand crossbow. He's going to go ahead and fire hand crossbow at you.
Oh, no.
13.
Wow.
That's my armor class right now.
That was quick.
7 points, bonk.
Yeah, down.
All right. As you fall to the ground, go ahead and make 2 death saves for me, real quick.
Oh, fuck.
Boy.
18 and 13.
Yeah, you're looking pretty good. In your vision now, as you begin to slowly black out, the familiar face of Saman, the ebony skinned man, the spy master of the group, stands before you. It's like, interesting. Take her weapons, and he looks at, he goes and takes her hand and pulls it over. He's like, I'll have Miss Etterton just examine this real quick. Take her back in there, healer. Put her to sleep. And before you use this, like, very large, sort of reddish tinted scaled lizard folk, not the same one that was in the bar, someone different, wearing the robes of Nyceralia. It's another pain master.
Oh, God.
He's like, of course. Can I make some? And Samaz was like, no, don't do that now. We'll wait until the interrogation. The lizard folk's like, damn. And he takes you with one hand and just pulls you back into the room and you black out again.
Oh, I'm very smart, guys. You know that? I'm just dance all the way.
All right, so I'm starting to think maybe I do have slightly not the worst plans.
Let me just teleport outside the store.
Let's just do it. Let's. I just looked up to the right, then I would have stopped myself, but no.
So you awake again, Tav. This time you have been strapped down to a chair. Your hands are on where the armrests are. There's like extended little metal plates where your hands sit out flat. And there's metal plates on the bottom where your feet are also flat as well. You notice that every finger has been bound to the table as well as your toes to the floor. So you're sitting like this.
No spells, basically.
you see that there's a rack of a little silver tray, but it's covered. But you can see the vague outlines of what looks like to be surgical tools right there. You see this large, very sort of ragged, scarred-looking lizard folk with red tinted scales. There are a couple pirates. There's one pirate behind you, and then the door is closed. And then behind the lizard folk is Saman. Go back to the map. Just for time. You don't have to go back to map. We're not doing anything crazy yet, okay. I guess. The lizard folk walks up to you. All right, awake, I see. And look, you are in a nice little pattern. All your fingertips and toes are nicely secured. As you see him pull up on your fingers, you know, bracing and rubbing against the metal ring that's bound to the plate on your chair, hurts. He takes off the tray, and you see all these horrifying tools to cut and break and bend. And you can only imagine what's going to happen next. The ebony skinned man, Saman, walks forward in his regal maroon and gold vestments, his robes. You see he still bears the somewhat bruising of Ox sleeper holding him. So you see him rubbing it from time to time as he walks up to you. He says, all right, so let's make this simple. Answer a few questions, and maybe we won't take all your fingers and toes. Okay.
Okay. What are questions? What do you want to know?
Just go ahead and get a simple one. What's your name?
Well, that's easy. It's Tab.
Tab.
Yeah, Tab.
Just Tab?
Yes, Tab.
Where are you from, Tab? And as he's continuing the question, you see the lizard book already has a set of pliers, and he is resting it on your pinky, your left hand.
Well, I'm from another continent. I'm just here on some, I would say business, but it's kind of become more pleasure recently.
Nods his head over at the lizard folk. And as soon as your eyes dart toward your finger, you hear a crack. We go back to the rest of the party. So, you arrive at the Gold Oasis Casino. You see that it's quite busy. The imposing Fort Abij overshadows this part of the city. But the Gold Oasis Casino, very large, rugged, square, golden ziggurat of sorts. There are many windows, glass panes, all around, and you can see that there's some large braziers and lanterns within to illuminate this ground floor, where they mostly play like shuffleboard, but it's on like a bigger board, along with your normal roulettes and card games, and dice games too. Probably holds about like 500 people. It's not that big, but it's big. Mm-hmm. So you see that there are some definitely disguised pirates. You can see underneath the disguises some of those tattoos that they have all over the body. So you can definitely scope out that there's roughly 10 out front, and then there's two alleys that lead to the back, which is sort of walled, and there is a back entrance where there are no also 10. These people are easily identifiable as pirates. They're just hanging around. There's some long tables where they're playing cards, they're drinking. Some of them are playing bags or cornhole. Mm-hmm. Back there. So yeah. So what's the plan? What do you two think you guys want to do? God only is up to you. He's like, look, I'm just here to help out and get Taff. I don't have a good plan either, because honestly, I'm raging with fury and all these people are evil. So I might go off the hinge as well, but I'm not going to. I'm going to hold myself.
So we should find a way to the roof.
Let's go to the roof. Okay. Are we all going to the roof?
I feel like if we split up, someone's gonna die, and it may not be the other guys. Some of the other guys will definitely die. But
who's all here, by the way? Who all came?
So it's I believe it's me, Sterling, Godelina, and
Laguna.
Laguna. But probably those are the only ones that I have
as well.
Okay, you want to bring Riccati? Do you want to bring anyone else?
No, I think I was. Stick with just for Cotty.
Okay. Now, I will say, Ox, that the trio of Tav, they probably would have heard from everybody. Mm-hmm. They were definitely adamant on going as well.
Okay.
So Orestes is already, even though Orestes and there are some thugs hired by you at the safe house, do you want to bring them as well?
I wouldn't bring them for combat more than anything. I would have them create a distraction so that we can, for the most part, go unnoticed.
Okay, so you want, so Stir, are you in agreement with that plan then?
Well, what do you mean by distraction?
I mean, just to, it may draw like maybe the bigger force out and try to get them to where, like, in the event that we can't avoid a sort of fight, they're weakened.
Gordolina agrees with that plan. She says, we need some sort of distraction. There are already a many guards down below in the first floor. We don't want them coming up from downstairs and making our escape a lot harder. First, we need to figure out our escape. How are we going to get on the roof, and how are we going to get off the roof?
How high is the back roof?
From ground up is 60 feet.
Now,
there are some buildings nearby. If you're looking to jump across, that's about a 15-foot jump on all sides.
I also have rope, so if that I too. Can get yeah. on one of the other things and maybe try to, you know, lasso something across the way to try to help with that jump.
Sure.
Okay. I would like to do that. I think okay, that's probably the best way to go unseen.
What is everyone else's? What is everyone else think? Gobelin is like, okay. Then yeah, it's gonna have to be a small party. So her and Laguna would only be the only ones going. It'd be probably best for the others to stay part due to distraction, and keep them away if that's the case. Because let's be fair, if those NPCs fail that climb check,
they're dead.
They're dead.
So I could. I'm just trying to think what distraction would be good enough that they could bring out people without, you know, also dying.
Well, I just look at Sterling and I go, just remember, arson is a crime.
Arson is a crime, and but I don't wink. Want my people to get arrested.
Godolina looks at you and she's like, no, we're not doing that. There are people inside there.
Oh, so we're near, what, like,
You guys are like at a nearby house over, like on the roof of a nearby house overlooking. You can see it. I'll just say that you guys are up on one of the roofs and you're a little overlooking. There are a couple of guards out there, but they're all like on the other side. So they can't technically see right now. So you guys are sort of like hiding, but you guys can scope out the roof and you can see that it's a 14-foot jump with the rope. You could find a couple of spots. Regardless, even making the full swing, you still need to climb probably 10 feet up once you hit the roof.
Once you hit, you know, yeah, since it's 15 feet, I can also bamf over there.
Okay, that's fine.
To secure the rope so that it helps them easily.
That's fine, but regardless, they have to climb themselves. Yep. No one else has fly or teleport, besides Godolina, but she's going to say fly.
Mm-hmm. Certainly doesn't have magic anymore, so he's
going to have to... He's not a wizard anymore.
Not a wizard. I feel like fire is not a good idea, especially if we're going inside the building and we're catching on fire. We've had a history of buildings falling on top of us. I don't feel like it's a great idea to let that happen again.
Well, is this a distraction? I didn't mean actually set the building on fire. Just make it so that they have to address it.
But I feel like it could be addressed by like one person. If it's just someone like starting to light a kindle. I feel like just starting to light a fire isn't a big enough distraction.
Okay, so just cause a ruckus downstairs, like a brawl. Have some of the guys run in, start stealing people's money and running around and just as an old TV show I saw from back at my home planet. It's like a Benny Hill sort of thing.
I don't know what that is.
it's a moving pictures with sound.
It's nonsense. I don't a moving picture.
Yeah, I'll show you one day.
But the issue is, I feel like if they go down there and make a ruckus, will they get captured? And then that's just...
Well, we just make sure they don't get captured, you know? Just if they feel like they're going to be in danger, get the fuck out. I don't know. They know what they can do best.
Normally says, let's put faith in them, but it's a good plan, I think. One, they're not actively engaging. They can run away and flee back into the city. As long as they can draw some of them away. At least the guards from downstairs. 20 is a lot already. There shouldn't be many more. I can only assume, Ox, that you killed a lot of them inside since there was a lot of blood in the tavern.
I mean, I did some stuff. There's also a bear.
Ricotti's just like, actually, Tav killed a lot of people.
Yeah.
And Gordon's like, that makes sense as well. So hopefully their numbers have thinned by then.
So
do we just send our people into their saying they want to gamble?
Unless you want me or Laguna to go, but I feel like you're going to need both of us going inside there.
Yeah. All right. That's better in a plan than what I got, so.
Okay. I think for right now, with time of the essence, we should probably just go with that one then.
All
right. Okay. So Ricotti looks to you, Story, and says, don't worry, Mr. Sterling. I got this. I already have a plan in action just for in case of this kind of scenario would have come across. Not that I thought Tav would get captured. Just if we needed to distract guards here, because I have been. Anyways, he moves on and he Gassan's with you. You said you brought Gassan.
Sure.
Okay. Oh no, did you not want to bring Gassan? You just want Ricotti?
If they're just gonna be distracting them, I think I'll bring all my members to do it because they're all able to use cunning action.
Okay. So the only one left, I'll say that Lorenza stayed home.
Okay.
Okay. at least one person there.
The boring one.
Right.
This seems too exciting for my blood.
But also, yeah.
I want to get a personality.
Yeah. Alright, so Givi and Vosu make their way with Orestes, Vrakati, and Kasan. You see that they are actually, they work well together, honestly. You and Ox sort of see your pupils work well together. You see them point out where to go, where to follow, where to lure them. And with that, Gordolina, you and Laguna, both of you, make your way to the rooftop. All right, so Ox, go ahead, throw that. You have a grappling hook too with that? Or no, you're just going to bamf with that.
Yeah, rope? I'm going to use one of my spell slots to just bamf across and secure the rope.
Okay.
So, and I'm also going to hold it just in case that rope comes untied from a shitty knot. That's
fine. You're gonna make a knot test. Berg, you start getting better at that, man. So you bamf over there. What does your bamf look like?
Effectively, it's mine is not so much smoke and mist as it is kind of sinking into a sudden puddle and then popping up from a puddle on the other side. With just trailing what looks like lines as my body erupts from the ground.
All right. With that, Gordolina holds on to the other, or no, Laguna holds on to the other end of the rope. Like, Laguna holds on first, but Laguna just snatches away from her, saying, "Are you kidding me?" Gordolina's just like, "I can hold my own." You bamf over there. You go ahead and secure it. So go ahead and make a dexterity check.
Oh, cool. Perfect. Yeah. At least I have a plus one, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
11.
11. You do a, you think is a good job.
Yep. Still holding the rope.
Holding the rope down. So go ahead and who's up first? Actually, Goldie will go first. Goldie will go ahead and fly, boom, boom, hits the side of the building. We should go ahead and make that climb check. I will say with advantage because you're holding the rope. That's a nine.
Wow.
I will go ahead and say that as she falls, she will have to use her fly so she can silently fly up to the roof, and she curses herself.
You know the disapproving look she's given me all these times? I just look at her as she comes over the edge, and I just go,
"Shut up, Bucks. She walks past you."
Smirk on my face.
All right, who's next?
I'll go last because I'm the heaviest. So.
All right. Laguna's going to take the rope. All right. And then Laguna. 12 passes. Climbs up relatively ease. And as he climbs up, he sort of just smirks at Gordolina. Gordolina is just clutching her sword. She's like, "I will cut both you up."
I'm just gonna wink at her at this point.
Go ahead, Sterling.
Just a dex check.
You just need to make a climb check, so it's athletics to climb up the rope. You're gonna swing better to the wall, but you're gonna have to climb up it. That's the real check.
I think we're all gonna try to help make sure that this doesn't go poorly. So,
well, it's all advantage. Yeah, you get advantage.
Oh, get advantage. I mean, it's fine, anyways. But okay, that was 12.
12. Yeah, you're good. You climb up as well. Gordolina and Ox help you up, and you're on the roof. All right. Everyone go ahead and make a perception check to see if you can find a way. There is a way from the rooftop. And as you're all making that, I will say, Tav, that you took 1 point of damage as two of your fingers have been broken now.
Okay. How much HP did they give me anything? Because then I'm...
You're at 10 HP, so now you're...
Okay. Okay, that's great.
Because I know that you're gonna be feeding for information, right? Because I assume that's why you're still here.
Yeah.
Why you haven't bamfed out yet? So, yeah. Saman already knows. He already sees that. He sees that you're not gonna give up anything really, unless like we do some real torture things, I guess. but at the same time, as it's happening, he's looking at the ring, that your ring. Your rapier's not there, obviously, but you can always summon it back. As the lizard folk breaks your ring finger on your left hand, Saman looks at him. "This ring, it's definitely magical. It's definitely what gives her the ability to teleport out of here. Yeah, you should take it." I will continue the interrogation. The lizard folk takes the ring and says, I can put this in the black jar. And Simone's like, I would assume you would put it in the black jar, so she can't use it for now. And the lizard folks heads to the door and makes his way out with your key, with your ring.
Okay. I'm going to wait like 5 seconds, or let's say 10 seconds. Then I'm going to take the ring back and that.
So that probably will happen as Mom begins to step forward again and says, by the way, if you're going to leave again, are you sure you're going to want to leave your little pets in the other room?
Oh, you mean Steven? He's not a pet. He's my son. Which way is that room? Can you tell me that? Can you be so nice just so I can think about him a little more?
He gets up. He walks out the door and he closes the door.
No. Okay.
Okay. So you reappear. I guess you come your ring in?
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
And I bamf out 30 feet this way out in the corridor. Then start running.
Okay.
So let's see here. It's 30 feet. I make it around the corner a little bit, like right there. 60 feet. A little bit there, but it's dark.
I can't see.
I can't see shit. Oh. So
as you bamf out, you see Simon turn around, you see the lizard folk, and you see Katja. And Katja is just like with her rapier out.
Which way is my boy?
All right, roll initiative.
Why? 14. Come on now.
I'll just go ahead. I'll roll for the pirates. So they are 3. Come on. Come on. Oh boy, okay, where are you? Oh, you're not here. You're here.
I thought that dude was in the room with her. How did he get out here?
He walked out.
Oh, that's... Oh, okay.
Yeah, that bastard? How dare he walk out?
What a jerk. Because I thought one of them was in there and the other one walked out with the ring.
Both of them eventually walked out.
Oh, okay. I was confused. Apparently, I don't know how to listen well.
Not me either. At least I have 9 HP now. Ooh.
Yeah.
That's not great. Come on.
Really got to start healing yourself before you're entering initiative on these.
Yeah, but I was hoping that they wouldn't be right there. So I would come around the corner and then have time to heal myself before I would die again, but let's see how this goes. Maybe they missed me with my 13 AC.
Simon is going to go ahead and immediately run into this hall, and he's going to open the door. It says, she's out again. She's armed. Just kill her. There's no use in this. And kill the other one, too. And he goes ahead and closes the door. Boom. All right. Then it's Tev.
Okay. I'm going to cast Cure Wounds. I only have first level, so let's do it. 8 more HP. That's great. And I can't use spells action. What do I have as bonus actions? Do a fighting, bardic inspiration. Can't do anything like that.
Tav is going to cast Badass Bitch.
Well, that's always a badass bitch. I can't do shit. I have no equipment. I can't do any spells. I can't even stab them right now. Let's see here.
Can't you spend your action to get your sword back?
Yeah.
Warlock?
Get my sword back.
You want to heal first.
Yeah, I wanted to heal, so. And I don't. And I'm going to see here. 30. I'm going to step back here. No, wait. Back there. And that's my turn. Fucking nice. Perfect.
So it's Kasha's turn. Kasha with Fury. Cannot get to you, so she's going to go ahead. Well, what do you have there? She has.
I see exactly what you did, Tap. Well played.
Yeah. If they don't have mobile feet or something, then probably I'm fine. Or long range. Something
she's
like
gonna
that.
She's going to go ahead and pull out her wombo. She's going to go fire shots at you.
Well, shit.
Almost.
So first one, 19. Third one, 9. Third one, 16. So all those two hit?
Two hits. Okay. Come on. I could have jumped into my
fucking ring. Yeah, that's what I would say.
That's 35.
Oh, oh. That's a lot.
Well, bye.
Go ahead and make your death saves. See if you die naturally.
I think Godolina has another 9,000 gold.
I thought it was 11.
11? It is 3,000.
3,000? No, 3,000 gold.
Oh, a one.
That's 2-1.
Let's see here. Come on. 12.
Oh. 2-2.
Okay, this is the last one. Come on now. That 20. Roll. Come on, that 20. Oh, 15. I'm not dead. I'm stable.
Okay.
Stable. I have a feeling that you're going to die anyways.
But yeah. as you flick your eyes, you see Kasha, and she takes a rapier. She just plunges it straight into your neck. And she will continuously do that as your eyes close. Tab, you have passed on.
Well, probably should just have gone torture. That would have been better.
All right, so the rest of the party. You're on the roof. What are you guys doing?
We're trying to find a way in, yeah. I had a perception check of 12.
Well, what was yours doing?
Oh, let me make that. 5.
5. Okay.
My passive is 15, if that helps.
Yeah, we'll go ahead and use passive. So what's everyone's passive perception?
11, or nope, 10, sorry.
And then yours is 15, Ox?
Yep. No, 14, sorry. Sorry, 14.
You do manage to find an alcove on the roof that does have what looks like to be a trap door, and there's a ladder, a collapsible ladder. But as you open it, the collapsible ladder is in there, but it looks like they sealed it with stone. But it looks like it's brittle enough for you to hack at it.
I could hack at it, or...
Or, yeah, whatever.
I'll just Eldritch Blast the shit out of it.
Sure, yeah, if you want to do that, go ahead.
Yep.
You just continuously just throw... What does your Eldritch Blast look like?
My Eldritch Blast is... I haven't thought of this one yet. This one's going to be fun. So it's... Damn, I really should have thought this one out. It's instead of like your standard beam, it's a beam of what looks like seawater that hits way harder than it ought to.
Okay. Bursting through cracks begin to form and begin to create divots within the hard stone. Eventually, it collapses by the amount of pressure and force with every torrent that you fling at it. And below, water seeps down, and you guys feel this heat and this disgusting stench, this aroma of burning flesh. We're going to go ahead and take a 15-minute break.
Oh, fuck.
The party enters.
Well, I sure hope no one's dead down there.
No one.
Oh, my God. We'll be back, everybody. Holy shit.
If Steven doesn't die, then I'm good.
We're back, everybody, from our short little break. Hello. That's all I got.
I'm dead.
All right. So let's get back into the City of Illumination. We return with our party. Was about to launch a rescue plan, a rescue operation, but the rescuee decided to take things in her own hands. Didn't make out the way she wanted to, but hopefully we'll see if the party can scrap a win for the team here today. some sort of win here today. So as you all open, Ox, as you fling one last Eldritch Blast, it breaks and creates this large indentation within the rock, bursting it downwards. You hear what sounds like a lizard. I was like, what the heck? Backing away from the hole that you just created above him. And you see in the corner a burning carcass. And it smells pungent. It's terrible. You can vaguely glimpse that the creature is bound. It's not moving. Are you going to jump in?
Yep, I'm going to.
I guess real quick. How about this? Real quick, let's talk about what I always want to do real quick, and then we'll jump right into it.
Okay.
So you were all on top of the hole. Ox, what were you thinking? You're going to jump in. What do you want
to do? I've got a couple different things that I was thinking about doing. I was either going to cast Armor of Agathys and then jump in, or, assuming I don't immediately touch anything, I was going to cast Invisibility and then jump in.
So everyone knows that there's another creature in there and that there's some other creature being burned in there. So that's what everyone knows.
Okay.
It's definitely a Rune of Swords. So that changes anything.
Okay.
Sterling, what are you thinking?
My options are kind of limited right now. So I guess I was going to... we're definitely like... known presence, right? To be busted in.
Well, I mean, the busting, yeah. I don't know if it's you particularly, but yeah, someone just busted in. Well, it's not like a massive explosion. It's more like rocks have fallen, hit. So, like, anything within the vicinity probably heard it. Anything outside may have heard the booming sounds of something hitting large stone. So, but no one bothered to pay attention below. But then again, you are trusting your people down there doing their job.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I think, but I won't drop in just yet. I'll start shooting at the lizard guy with my crossbow before anything.
Okay. Laguna's going to jump in.
Yeah, okay, so I'm going to...
Laguna, thanks, dude.
All right, I'm going to use Armor of Agathys.
Okay.
And I'm going to jump in, and I'm immediately going to try to take out that lizard guy before he can run and tell anybody. Okay, so that gives me an additional 10 temporary HP.
Plus 5 cold damage, yeah?
Well, it's based on the level. So, it's 10 each time they hit me until it's gone.
Each time they hit you, okay. Cool. Alright. Thinking of Bob, here you go. Alright, so I'll go ahead and bring you back to the map. Darkness. That's all you see.
I don't have magic missile for this moment.
but you do see a burning corpse, and Steven's like rolling outside. He's definitely, when you get down there, it's Steven. He's bound by several layers of chain, and he's just rolling in the fire.
Oh my god, that just looks terrifying.
No, oh god.
Gordolina is going to be with Sterling above, helping out, I guess. So yeah, so you're going to try to, what are you doing with this guy again?
Well, I mean, if I don't trust Laguna to try to save Steven, so I'm going to assume Laguna is going to go after this dude, and I'm going to try to get Steven out of the fire.
All right, so we'll start with Sterling. Sterling, go ahead and make your attempt shot. The lizard folk who's wearing vestments of Nicerelia. It's another pain master.
Oh, great. The 15.
15 will... I hope it is.
Rolling very low today. Couldn't roll higher than that 7.
Jeez.
That is. What the hell is it? For you? You are. Yeah, that is.
Alright. Do this, and since Ox is down there, I'll also take my sneak attack.
Yeah. Ox and Laguna down there.
Yeah, so it's 11 damage in total.
1 damage in total, nice. The bolt flies and just misses his neck, but hits him right in the shoulder, the collarbone. He's like, ah!
Do I get to make a second attack, or is this just a surprise round?
Yeah, I'll give you a surprise round, so go ahead.
Does my crossbow, can it just be reloaded twice in the same round?
No, it has a loading feature, I believe, doesn't it?
Okay. I'll throw my dagger at him then, because I don't want to shoot yet. 23
definitely had.
So 7 damage.
Alright. He's looking pretty beat up, close to bloodied. As the dagger goes right into his knees, or like above his kneecap, he's like, ah! Right?
And then
Scrappy, what are you doing here?
I am Scrappy.
Now I know why he hates you so much.
I'm the dagger to his butt.
I'll just stay up there for this turn.
All right. Laguna's gonna go ahead and try to do something with this guy, I guess. Maybe. Laguna's gonna go ahead and he's enraged. So we're gonna go ahead and rage it up, boy. So he does yell really loud. I'm gonna slaughter everybody here.
Oh God.
Okay.
All right. So here we go. First of two attacks. Hits.
Oh shit.
Well, I'm just gonna do normal attacks. He was only using one hand because he was flicking him off while he was attacking him. So
cocky bastard.
Yes. So here's the first one. That's the crits, and then here's the max damage. So that's 26 points in total. Laguna just kicks the guy in the knee, sort of breaking his knee down, so he falls to one knee, his other knee, and he just cleaves upwards, ripping him backwards into the door itself, and then he just impales him through the shoulder into the door. 26. Yikes, he is bloodied. He's beaten, and he's also prone. Again, he's also stuck to the door by Laguna. Okay, Ox, what are you doing?
I am. I'm trying to. I'm just gonna pull Steven out of the fire.
Sure. Yeah, you can pick him up. You're just gonna just take fire damage.
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay. And you just take 6 points of fire damage.
All right. The fire takes 10 points of cold damage.
Fire takes 10 points of cold damage. Steven takes 10 points of cold damage.
No, he doesn't.
He can if he wants to.
No, he doesn't want to. That's fucked up.
Okay. So, yeah, you have Steven. You got cool.
Yep.
Going is just like, all right. What the? Oh, my God. Halo, preserve him.
I want to. So you said Steven is like chained up. So, I mean, can I use part of? I don't know. I was pulling him off. Can I try to get him free?
That's gonna go ahead and start the next turn. So, we'll roll for initiative.
Okay.
God, I am not rolling good today. It's a 12.
Still better than me.
It's only because I have +8.
All right, Ox, what do you got?
4.
9.
You got a 9, so you only got a 4?
I got 12. 4 plus 8.
That's right, because you have alert. Okay. I think that's it. I guess the pain master for right now, until everyone else is like, what's going on? Pain faster. I wrote them. Okay, what the hell? All right. 20. Oh, Jesus. These guys.
Oh my God.
Oh God.
Well, 18 plus. Jeez, I only have a +1 of those guys. 19. All right.
Guys are so prepared.
Yeah, he's so ready for this.
Minus the fact that he's stuck to a door.
To a door, yeah. So Godolina is technically right here along with you, Sterling. So you guys are about So about 8 feet. So just, I'll say 5 feet, but you're technically 8 feet away or above all this crap going above and whatnot. The door is still locked, but you hear, all of you hear another pirate's like, "Oi, what's going on? Holy crap, there's, oi, we've been attacked. There's someone in here. What's going on? First the demon lady just fucking teleports everywhere." This magical fire will eventually vanish. Painmaster. Okay, Painmaster. Can't believe you're going first, but here we go. She's not grappled. She's just, her movement is zero. So she can still attempt to get out. Mm-hmm. Or she can step to, she can now break free to move. Or actually, you can just do action. So we're just going to do actions. So she's going to go ahead and polymorph Laguna. So Laguna, because he's a problem. He needs to be taken care of.
He is the biggest threat in the room right now, according to that Bane Master.
Yeah. He's a big, yeah, of course, easily, because he's sticking to the wall, dude. He doesn't know about your fucking destruction or Sterling's, really. And Goldalina's. All right, so he has a pause. I will say, okay.
I honestly, part of me hopes he fails.
Wow.
Just so he can get turned into something, I can be like, I saved your life.
He passed.
Damn.
Yeah. As he this dark watery tendril, almost like yours, but definitely different. Yours is sort of a murky green emerald. Narsarelli is just straight dark waters. Mm-hmm. Is beginning to creep around him from her hands, his hands, but eventually is just dissipates as Laguna just tightens his, or pushes deeper into the door. He's like, "You gotta be joking." And the Painmaster just, and his right arm just goes limp. And he's like, "All right, Sterling."
Okay. I will take my second shot at the Painmaster. Or are we trying to keep him alive?
No, not this doing one.
No, all right. Great.
No, no pain masters will ever survive.
I'll shoot him with my crossbow, which is a 23, so it hits. And then damage is, well, minimum damage on that, and then 7 damage in total from the crossbow.
The damage total. With that bolt, it goes right into his left eye, and it pales into the door. He's dead.
Nice.
Laguna looks up at you, Sterling. He's just like,
all right, now is really not the time to be getting pedantic about this.
Shut up. He hacks at the door, Nosca. It's not starting yet.
I'll drop down now, and then I will tiptoe around
to the window.
Okay. And I'll peek through the door.
Okay. Peek through the door.
Now, I don't want to fully open it. Just like crack it open.
Okay, you're gonna. Okay, so it's locked right now. There's someone
it's
trying to
locked.
Get in.
Locked.
Yeah,
okay.
Someone trying to get in. Yeah. Oh no, sorry. Oh. It's locked, but someone's opening the door right now. Someone's opening the door. My bad. Because
okay.
It's not his turn yet.
I have my second attack. Can I ready that attack, or does that have to be my full action?
That has to be your full action. Yeah.
Hopefully. Okay. I will. What do I have? I will just take the what can I do with my bonus action? Death, disengage, or hide. I will. How is this room like? Can I hide in like one of the corners away from this person?
Yeah, that's fine. That's totally fine. Yeah.
I'll take my bonus action to hide in the corner and then wait.
Sure. All right, let's go, Ox.
All right. I'm gonna. I was going to ready an action to, like, the minute they open that door, like, just try to cleave their hand off. But I am going to use my action to free Steven from his bindings.
All right, go ahead and make a strength check.
Okay. Shit, here we go. 19.
19. You break those chains easily. Steven bursts, like, over here, hits the wall, and he starts, like, feeling his flesh, and he's just like, ah!
I just look at Steven. I'm like, save that for the guy outside.
So, Yanni, Steven is at 1 HP currently. So, he'll, after next turn, next turn, he's not going to regen. But after next turn, he can start regen again.
Yeah. Should he roll initiative?
Yes. Now he can roll initiative. Anything else, Ox?
Do have a bonus action. I am going to summon a tentacle of the deep right inside the door.
Okie dokie. Tentacle of the deep as a bonus action.
My tentacle of the deep looks like jellyfish stingers.
Nice. How's it summoned again? Summoned from the ground up?
Yep, it's summoned from the ground up. So these right, little tendrils of like itchy, ouchy, wibbly wobbling from the floor.
Wobble, wobble.
Right. See what you did there. I've got so many bonus actions now. It's amazing.
Man.
Ooh, fancy.
It'd be a large crystal, but
yeah, okay. It works.
Eventually, I'll find something that looks gnarly. There you go. I call it Tenti.
Tenti.
Yeah, oh, God.
Nice.
All right. This greenish, murky water tentacle, jellyfish sort of pseudopod appears in front of the doorway. Laguna just looks at you and he's like, new training methods?
Something like that. And I just stare at the door waiting for some idiot to open it.
Who has the higher initiative, Steven or Sterling? Dexterity.
My dexterity is only plus 3.
That's Steven's also, but he can go after Sterling.
Okay, that's fine. Yeah, you guys can decide whoever. You can actually switch, which I'll allow. It's totally fine. If you want to go first this turn or whatever. All right. Went to the pirates. Opening the door is boom. Byron number one. Here you go. you're holding your. You know who's holding action? Yeah.
No. I mean, okay, I couldn't hold an action. So.
So Pyro opens the door. He's like. With his hand axe out, he's like, "Oh shit!"
I'm just smiling at him.
Laguna's like licking his axe. Like, ah.
Oh god!
I forgot to roll Golina.
This guy has the right idea. He's wearing the brown pants.
No one's gonna know he shit his pants. No one will. Golina has a 16. All right, cool. So she's technically first next. Second. All right. She would have hopped in. She's going to go ahead and heal Steven for 15 points. Take it all, Steven. And she like she puts her hand on like his thigh and like scratches it. He's like, and his leg like twitches. Like, yes. And Golina's like, this is the last time I'm doing that. He's like, no. All right. Pirate's gonna go ahead and leave. He's gonna go ahead and about to leave, but Laguna's gonna go ahead and take the attack of opportunity. misses. Wow. Boy. The guy's just so scared he pulls the door far faster than Laguna can hit because he was licking his sword, making it look cool. He's, oh shit. Misses.
But you get
shit. Pulls the axe out of the door. And Gordolina's like, wow, we're all just taking L's today.
shit talk from Gotolina. Well done.
He's been holding it in for quite some time.
She's got to be so angry with all of her choices.
Yeah, she is. She can't wait to be done with you all.
Just until you knew you had a soul.
Yeah. He's a very hard-line, like, zealot celestial. Like, she was raised by them, like, not medwise. But yeah. So she didn't know. So she's like, I'm going to leave it be. Mm-hmm. He's trustworthy enough, is what Gormley first thought. So, let's see. I'm going to move them. Oh, look at me moving around. All right. Go ahead. Paymaster's dead. So being so sturdy. No, sorry. Gordolina is first. Gordolina's going to go ahead and he's going to go ahead and open the door. And just, yeah, we're going to do it. Right, boom, kicks on the door, attacks this guy.
Sometimes you get the W, sometimes you get the L. Hey, Gordolina.
And then slice his head off, I think.
Oh, never mind.
one swipe. After she misses the first time, the pyromancer dodges. She hears that remark. She lets go of her blade to fix her grip, and she pulls it upwards and slices it off.
And that's when I go, nope, never mind.
Gordolina pushes the door aside. She says, all right. Sees another guy. With that free attack, well, unfortunately, she went first, so she's not really... It will do any much with her ability as a sword, which sort of sucks. So she's going to go ahead and move forward, and that's it. So we'll go ahead, Steven or Sterling, whoever wants to go first.
Sterling, you go first.
All right.
You don't know what's on the side, but you definitely know that the guard that tried into the door is definitely dead.
There.
All right, you see another pirate who's like pulling out his hand crossbow. He's like, oh, no.
Oh, no,
they're escaping again. How many escapes are happening?
I'll take my bonus action to dash so I can get there. I want to that site, and then I'll shoot him with my crossbow.
Sure.
15
will hit. That's it.
Okay. And then that's going to be 6 damage.
6 damage, okay.
And then I'll throw my dagger because I can't do much else.
You definitely
14.
Hit. 14. He's going to go ahead and dirty fight. Oh, no, you're too far away. Yeah, I'm going to say that it has to be a certain range. So, yeah, you're too far away for dirty fighting. He's very upset about that. You see him grab some, like, sand he throws, and the sand just disperses, like, 5 feet just in front of you, and you're just like, fuck you. all right, so what was your roll to hit?
14.
14 definitely hits.
Another 5 damage.
How do you kill this pirate with your dagger throw?
Through the neck, as per usual. Just trying to get through all these people as fast as possible.
All right. Steven, go ahead. Oh, no, is that it for you, Sterling?
Yes.
All right. Steven, what are you doing?
He's going to move here and be ready, holding action to attack if someone comes within 5 feet. Does he heal, or is it next turn?
Next turn.
Yes?
Yeah. Oh, no, he does heal because he got healed by Gordolina.
Yeah. So okay. Healed. 6. Nice. Done.
All right. Ox.
All right. I am going to be moving. What is this? This thing moves 30 feet? I can move it 30 feet? Good, the tentacle?
Yeah.
Okay.
It moves 30 feet on the bonus action, yeah.
Okay. Bonus action. I'm just going to put it here, but it's where... It's like around Stephen. I'll just be on top of that. I'm going to move down there. I am actually going to go get out of here. I'm going to do a dash action to come around the corner and go here so I can see what's going on down there.
Yeah, Laguna actually forgot to do his turn. He would have saw that too. All right, yeah, cool. Anyways, you'll see around that corner?
All
right. So to your well, never mind. Why would I say that? To your displeasure, you see a corpse riddled with stab wounds of Tav. They looks like these two pirates are gonna pick her up and take her out to the trash can or burn her or whatever. You see one rowdy, another one with a tricorn hat, just like, all right, take her out, but oh shit. And you see the lizard folk guy from the scorpion, the one that has the spirit shroud thing. Mm-hmm. He has a spear. He's like, fuck.
The minute I see Tav's lifeless corpse, just a guttural roar. And I just look at all of them and just say, oh, you picked a great day to die! Right.
The lizard folk prepares himself. This guy also pulls a hand crossbow. These two drop the body, Tav's body, and pull out their axes and hand crossbows as well. All right, so pirate's turn. He's be like, Miss Edendon, you need to flee! Vapu, get out of here and get your sword! He's gonna go ahead and he's gonna stay right here. He's gonna have his spear at the ready. He's gonna take the dodge action. And then this guy's gonna go over here. He's gonna go over here. And then, you know what? These two are gonna fire their hand crossbows at Laguna. And then this one's gonna go ahead and fire his at you. But you will get +1 to your AC for being behind those crates.
Cool.
All right, so the seafarer over here.
Come on, miss.
Seafarers. Uh, 13 misses. And then his second shot is, oh no, he doesn't have one second shot. So he's going to go ahead and move over yonder. These two on Laguna. Both miss. All right.
Thanks.
All right, so they fail, and they're going to go ahead and move this way as well. And then bursting through the door, you hear a familiar firbolg womanly voice saying, is the half-orc up there? Oh, I can't wait.
I'm going to kill this lizard first.
All right, we'll move on to top of the order, Godwina. Godolina is going to go ahead and move over here. How much is that? That's 15, 20, so 30 feet. And then we're in the prison order. No, I'm not guessing something. She's going to go ahead and fling magic missile at the lizard folk. She points her sword and pulls out her amulet. She mutters in celestial, and three golden arrows appear in front of her sword, and they fire at him. He's gonna go ahead and take 10 points of magical damage. That's it for Godolina.
This Wayne. Is how he gets summoned back. He dies in this world.
Or he just becomes that one lizard folk you just kill every day, I guess. Move on to Steven or Sterling, whoever wants to go.
Sterling, you go. I can't all do right. much.
I can't do too much either. A little bit low on items. Go right here. And there are enough people for me to justify a shot with my musket. I'll shoot at the lizard right here.
Yeah.
22, so. Definitely. And then, ooh, max damage, 16. And then they all have to make DC 14 dex saves.
We're getting deck saves, so we'll go with the seafarer up top. 20, he's good. And then Dolry, the lizard folk. Oh, wow, Dolry, you are pretty slow. 15 still passes, surprisingly. And then the two schmucks down here. Schmuck number one, schmuck number two. So two of those fail. So these two schmucks fail.
Okay, so two schmucks are going to take seven damage.
Seven damage. They're bloodied as the explosion from your Exandria bullets impacts behind Dolry. Dolry dodges and hits the wall, and the other one as well, flying backwards but retaining their position. Okay.
And then I have my second attack, which I will pull my crossbow and I'll shoot the lizard man again.
Okay.
Ooh, that's really low. 12.
Well, 12 will not hit the lizard man. And the lizard man does not like that you call him lizard man. Even though it's technically true.
He's a lizard day.
I'm a lizard folk.
Folk.
It's folk. I'll take my bonus action to like hide behind these crates if I can do that.
I mean, they're large enough for you to hide behind. So like you basically are behind total cover, so they can't see you.
All right. And that's where I end my turn.
Just straight in front of me, and I'm just like, what the shit?
Sorry, I just really don't want to get hit right now.
Yeah, Steven is going to charge the lizard man.
Sure.
An attack. Hopefully. Let's see, the first one, 4 plus 6, so 10, doesn't hit.
Sure.
And that 20.
Woo!
Yes, that's 2d6 plus 8. Plus 4, I mean. 12 damage.
Okay.
And he's going to bite. And that's a...
He's definitely bloodied at the point.
That's a 9, so that doesn't do anything.
Nope.
And that's it for Steven.
All right. Steven runs around the corner, obviously angered and furious, jumps on Dolry, the lizard folk, and just starts ripping him on the top of his upper body, ripping off part of his scales, even like cutting through his eyeball. But Dolry manages to kick him and use his tail to whip him back, repelling him for the moment. All right. So we move on to Laguna. Laguna's going to go ahead and barge on forward as well. he's going to go ahead and put one attack on this guy to get some blood in. Wow.
Ooh.
He trips up and just hits him in the knee. He gets up. He has to waste a second attack. Also has to waste half his movement, the rest of his movement. He hits him. What a waste.
He's also slapping at him from behind the crate.
And 13, he kills the guy, slicing him in half. He's so pissed. He goes ahead and I forgot to rage again because I need to blow another rage for my incompetence. All right. That's it for Laguna. Nox.
All right. I'm going to move here. And let's see what I'm going to do. I'm not going to blow my rage just yet. I am, however, going to spend my bonus action to activate my blade, announcing my presence. And actually, you know what? No, I won't. I won't, because I don't want to draw too much attention up here. That's a little bit too loud. Maybe a short burst would be fine. So instead of using that, I am going to use my bonus action to pull this thing. This thing can basically go through walls, right?
Yeah, you can teleport it to somewhere wherever you can see 30 feet from you.
Okay, so I'm gonna move it here so it's within 10 feet, so it's got that range. So I can I can hit. I'm gonna hit it. Try to hit him first with the tentacle.
Yeah, go ahead.
Where the hell is that? Oh, this is my spells. Wrong thing. Actions. Tentacle. Plus 5 to hit. Jesus, that misses. 6.
Yes, 6 does miss as he sort of swats it back with his own tail.
All right, I'm going to reckless attack and use a booming blade.
Okay.
So let's go ahead and try to hit with advantage. Oh, Jesus, 15. I think that just barely hits him.
15 hits him.
Okay, so that is 2 dice 6. That's 10 magical slashing plus spells. Booming blade is what? 2 die 8. Okay. And 4 thunder damage. That was underwhelming.
Four thunder damage. Still, he is close to being beaten. He's definitely feeling it. All right. Is that a few bucks?
That's it.
All right, to the pirates. So, bursting through the door is the firbolg woman up here. She has a great sword in hand. She yells out at the lizard, Dalry, how have you not taken care of this already? Dalry's just like, I'm trying.
He's like, I'm dying.
So we're going to go ahead with the right here. It's going to go ahead and back away. It's going to go ahead and fire a shot at Laguna. He will get sneak attack with hand crossbow. All right, so it does not crit, but one hits, or one his attack hits. Let me go ahead and do. Sixteen points of piercing damage on Laguna. You bet he's not raging, so he actually takes the full.
Oh my god.
I'll go ahead and attack Laguna as well to get sneak attack. Hits him. 4-3. Goes like, stop it.
What the hell do you think you're doing?
We're gonna go ahead and move Vapu over here. And she will go ahead and unload on Laguna. And Laguna just like, and this for the first time seeing this massive four-bolt woman, and she just and Laguna just like, huh? What the hell are you? Oh, he's about to feel the pain now.
Kind of glad he's in front of me.
Yeah, very much so. A big grin appears on Ox's face.
Now you understand what it's like to be a frontline fighter.
All right. She does not have advantage, so here we go. First attack on Laguna misses. Hilarious. Second attack misses. As Laguna just sort of like punches her like forearms when she tries to swing. She's like, get away from me. And the third attack will hit him, I think. Yes. It just hits him. Nice. All right. Well, not nice, because this is going to happen. All right. He takes 9 points damage. All right, because she's not raging yet. So here we go. I forgot to rage. No. Actually, no. I still have bonus. So she will go ahead and rage now. I should have done it earlier, but I'm an idiot. And also, there's so many barbarians on the field. Sort of annoying.
If it requires an action, the minute I see her like bulk up and rage, I'm just gonna be like, don't hit her.
Yeah, you can yell that out. Laguna will, we'll see if Laguna listens. We'll go ahead and go lean on top of the order. Go lean, just like, God, this is clusterfuck. All right. She's already blown spell slots there.
Where's the lizard dude's turn? Where's his at?
He's on the pirate.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I pulled them all together.
Cool.
All right, so she's going to go ahead and just magic missile. Well, no, she's going to go ahead and magic missile the firbolg.
I just said don't attack her. God damn it. She's going to get a look.
9 points of damage.
What the shit? So mad.
All right, Colin's like, and that's it for Galena. We want Steven or Sterling, whoever wants to go.
Steven can probably kill that guy in front of him to begin with.
Yeah.
See if he does it.
Oh, I forgot to do the skill guy. That's why. Damn. Yeah, I forgot to do him.
Oh. Nice. What is it? 14?
14. Pretty sure he does hit him. 15, 14 hits him.
Yeah.
Cast hits him.
Yeah, that's 5 damage on the first one.
Sure.
That's a 2, so that misses. And he bites, and that's an 11.
11. He uses the tail once more, powerful, and just swats Steven away. Still got a cut on him, though, but he's still alive. Pretty much beaten at this point.
Bitch. Yeah. That's it for Steven.
All right, Sterling.
Got a heal, right. So.
I will. Do I have clean line of sight on the lizard guy?
Yeah, you do. That's fine.
All right. I'll use my crossbow. Let's see. Yeah, 30, 20, so. That and then also get sneak attack. So, what? 5, 6, 8 damage in total.
How do you end the lizard folk guy?
Steven's just like burrowing into him, just like scratching at him, and then Sterling takes a shot and shoots him through the eye.
Falling forward, Steven looks really. and the woman's here is furious. She's like, no! All
right. I'm just going to peek around Laguna and smile.
Yeah, I'm going to, speaking of making her furious, I'm going to go right here. Not right there. That's too close. Can I stand in Steven's spot just for like a second and move back away?
That's fine.
I'll stand here, and then I want to throw a dagger at her.
Mm-hmm. That's fine. As long as you have the movement, I don't care.
Yeah, because I'm going to use my bonus action to dash. So, mm-hmm. Oh, it's a 12.
12 is not hit her.
All right. Well,
actually, it just gets stuck in her shoulder, and she just tightens her muscle, and it bounces out or flies out.
Whoa.
I think...
That's a woman.
From the Midwest.
Yeah. I'll pick up the dagger I threw. I think who was it? The lizard guy. I think I threw a dagger at, and I picked that up and run back away.
Okay, sounds good. We move on to Laguna. Laguna's going to go ahead and rage. And he's not going to devouring rage yet, but he's just going to go ahead and rage. And he looks at the furball and he's like, oh, you think you're tougher than me?
My face goes from a smile to a uh-oh.
So we'll go ahead and start with Laguna. First attack. And you, he doesn't have, did he have work attack? Let me see if he does.
I think it's just a barbarian thing.
I don't think he has it.
Oh, I guess he's something else.
Yes, he does have reckless attack. All right. I don't know if he had it, like if he had it as well. He has a bunch of things, but he's mostly barbarian, but there okay. are some stuff that he does have. So he's going to go ahead and reckless attack. Yay.
Yay.
Right, first attack definitely hits, and then we'll just go ahead with second attack definitely hit. And he will go ahead and use both hands on his battle axe. That's a lot of damage. 14, not a lot of damage. Dude rolled really low. That's 14 points is nothing. Like, nah! It just cleaves good chunks of her flesh up, but she is doesn't look like she's deterred by any of this. She's like, I'm going to kill all of you. Okay, you're pretty strong. But tough. All right, that's it for Laguna, so good ox.
All right. Bonus action. Gonna move this over here. And I'm gonna hit this dude with the tentacle, hopefully. We'll see how that works out.
The door is open over here, so I'll also reveal the room.
Okay.
Yeah, go ahead and do your tag. All
right. Tentacle of the Deep. That's a 24 to hit.
24 hits?
7 cold damage, and his movement is reduced by 10 feet.
Yep.
And then he'll get an attack of opportunity. That guy will, because I'm going to go around and flank her, since apparently everybody and their mom has decided to... Actually, you know what? No, I'm going to do something else entirely. I'm going to go over here. I'm going to launch a Eldritch Blast at that guy.
Yeah. Well, Laguna doesn't know what your shield does, and neither does Golina, so... They don't know what it does. They just have this icy little thing on you. I don't know. Do you think it's cosmetic?
Yeah, it's fancy, yeah. So, spells. We're going to go ahead and Eldritch Blast number 1. That is 18 to hit.
Definitely hits.
That is 5 force damage.
What, force damage?
And if he's not dead...
No, he's still alive. He's not even
okay.
Bloody.
Dirty 20.
Definitely.
6 force damage.
6 points damage. So he is still not bloodied yet.
Okay. Well, in that, well, I was hoping I could take him out, but I guess I'm going to go over here. So
yeah, these guys are a lot more equipped, more elites than these normal pirates.
Okay. So I'm going over to flank Firbolg.
Mm-hmm, sure.
And so hopefully no reckless attacks next time. So yeah, he'll get an attack of opportunity. 14 is my AC.
Okay. So he will go ahead and use his rapier. 22 hits. Wow. Jeez Louise, guys. That's going to be 9 points of piercing damage.
And he takes 10 cold damage.
He's 10 cold, and now he is bloodied.
As my shield explodes.
All right. We want to do the pirate's turn. We're going to go ahead, and he's like, oh, what the heck is that? Actually, there's stairs below you. They lead down probably to the lower floor, mm-hmm. and obviously downstairs. Right. This guy's just like, oh, wow, we're fucked. he's going to go ahead and attack you.
Mm-hmm.
First attack. Oh, wow, 18. Second attack, 14.
Yep, hits me.
Damn. Right. So total is 5 points of slashing damage. Or eight points of slashing damage, sorry.
Okay.
You're raging, yeah?
Nope, not yet.
All right, so that's it for him. This one right here is going to go ahead and continue to... He's going to just move slightly back, and then he's going to go ahead and fire at you with his hand crossbow.
What a bitch.
Does a sneak attack. Oh, yeah, dude.
Come up and say that to my face.
18 hits.
Yeah.
And that's going to be... 12 points of piercing damage.
Now that guy has my attention.
and then moving through the doorway is this Triton woman. Young looking woman, but she's heavily tattooed throughout her body. She's wearing this nice crimson sort of outdoor jacket. Her hair is tied nicely in a bun. She has a beautiful rapier at her side, but she has a bunch of tattoos that sort of remind you, Ox, of all the markings back in Nice Sorelia's temple. Back when you were taken by the seas. Mm-hmm. And you hear this guy's like, Miss Edited, please, we can take care of this. You should flee. And the Trident woman's just like, no, I think we settled this here now. There's no way putting it. So I've already sent the rest away. So she's now joining in with them. But I won't do anything with her. Actually, I will. She actually was moving last turn. So she actually can't do anything. So... I'm gonna go ahead and cunning action god behind the door.
Hmm.
All right. This one now we just go, I guess, the main one. So the furball can go ahead and unleash all of her attacks on Laguna. And Laguna's just like, oh shit. All right, so first one, normal, 13 misses. Second attack, 15 misses, and then final attack misses. Laguna holding his own against this rampaging Firbolg.
Now, as much as I want to win this fight, she has advantage on those attacks because he recklessed.
That's right. So for the 13, it's a 13 and a 14, and then a 15 and a 15, and then a nope, still does not hit.
Okay. Laguna.
Yeah, damn. All right, well, that's unfortunate. So we move on to Godelina. Godelina's going to be like, oh, shit. 25, we're going to get into the thick of it. So first sword attack, both hands miss. God damn. Second attack, god damn, misses. Oh, my God. That's it for Godelina. Steven or Sterling? Jeez.
You want to go, Sterling?
Not too much I can do right now, so...
Okay, I'll go. Just move up there and start shopping the bitch, the nice person.
Yeah. She was reckless attacking, so you do have advantage.
Yay! Anyways,
also, yeah. So.
See here. 18 plus 6. So let's just roll definitely everything to go. 16. Does 16 hit?
Yeah.
Yeah, and the last one is 20. So not net. So okay. Everyone hits. Oh, yeah. So that's 8 plus 12, so 20 damage.
Only take half, but she is still currently raging because of that.
Yeah.
Boom, boom. All right. Johnny?
I will. Okay. I will move right, I guess, here. Can I get, when I say on this guy right here?
Okay.
No, there was one up here. Yeah.
Yeah, you can get as long as that's fine.
Right. And now shoot my crossbow at him.
Sure.
That's a 25, so.
Yep, for sure.
11 damage.
11 damage. He's beaten.
Then I will throw my dagger. Because.
Why not?
Which else? 17. So assume it hits.
Yep.
Six damage.
Once again, another dagger goes through this pirate's throat. He's dead.
I will take my bonus action to really come on. I move from here, so it's like I can go like right there. I'll take my bonus action to disengage so I can get attack opportunity on her. And can I see what's...
You will not be taking attack opportunity on you. You're not her focus. You don't even have to spend that.
Alright. But can I see from here what's in the room or do I get closer?
You're going to have to go to the doorway.
Alright. Well. I guess if I don't have to use disengage, I'll use dash instead.
So at the doorway, you're technically right here. And he's... He is technically right there. As you get to the doorway, she will pounce on you.
Damn it. I knew it.
And with that, she gets surprised, so she will get sneak attack on that as well.
Getting a... Oh, damn. Because... I said, stop before getting surprised. Sneak attack, huh?
First one definitely hits, and then her second attack definitely hits. So two dirty 20s. That's good.
Yeah, Sterling, that's good. You got hit, right? That was great.
Good, yeah. Great, love it.
It's the best day ever.
So you take 30 points of Christian damage.
Ooh, boy, that's more than half my health. Right. 30 points.
You see that she has refined work. She definitely was like classically trained, and you sort of. It looks like her form is from the Principality of Dusinia, which is in the Empire out back where you're from. So it looks like she was classically trained, so she's definitely not going to be an easy challenge.
Well, I can't move away now, or I'll get attack opportunity. Yeah. So I'll just stay there, I guess.
Okay. We move on to Laguna. Laguna's going to go ahead and try to pummel this bitch into submission because he is furious that he hasn't whomped her already. First attack just hits, second attack misses.
He has advantage because I'm across from him, right?
Oh, shit, you're right. God damn it.
Like I said, everybody's getting what they need.
Still misses, yeah.
Jeez.
Yeah, it's fucked. All right, so there's 9 points of damage to her.
Wow.
Is magical, so she's still kicking. Damn, dude. Like this, dude, I'm doing bad today now. That's it for him, so Ox.
All right. I know about that fucker's dirty fighting, so I'm not going to mess with him right now.
He's like, come on, someone hit me.
That's some bullshit. No, I'll wait for him to do something dumb. I am...
He's holding fan, dude. He's like, come on.
I'm going to go ahead and bonus action rage.
Okay.
Action rage, which gives me what's gonna happen. That's the tentacle of the deep. There we go. Rage. Let's see what magical ability happens. That would be a 3. An intangible spirit which looks like a flump or pixie of your choice appears within 5 feet of one creature of your choice you can see within 30 feet of you. At the end of the current turn, it explodes, and each creature within 5 feet must make a dex save or take a d6 force damage. I can do that again as a bonus action on each turn. So, 30 feet. Let's take a look here. Perfect. It's going to pop up right here.
Yeah.
Yeah, there we go. I was like, that's fucking badass. All right, so at the end of my turn, that thing's going to explode. Dex check, all that stuff.
Is it just her?
Yeah. I purposely made sure that Sterling wasn't in range.
There you go. Cool, cool.
And then I have advantage on my attack. I'm going to, do a booming blade and try to strike at the Firbolg with advantage. Please roll something other than shit. 21.
21, definitely.
All right. That is max damage on the swing itself. That is 15 magical slashing. And... oh, max damage, 16 thunder.
16 thunder. She is beaten, and she's barely holding herself upright, using her sword as a cane.
Submit. That's all I say. And then I look at the guy right next to her, the one with sand in his hand.
Yeah, he dropped the sand already.
And that's my turn. So, let me see what I think it's only like, I gotta see what the save is for it, but I don't think it's very high.
The dex save, yeah?
Yeah.
21.
Yeah, well, yeah, she made it. So I don't think she takes anything.
Okay.
But I'll double check real quick. Where the hell is this? Okay.
Pirates. We're just gonna go at it. We're gonna. He's gonna be like, this guy seems weaker, so he's gonna attack Laguna. And Laguna's just like, oh, you saw? I'm weaker. How is this happening?
Saw what happened with my one swing.
Here we go. Misses and misses. Laguna like kicks both his time. Like, you gotta be kidding me. And then she's gonna go ahead and unload on you now. Oh, she'll throw one attack on you.
Mm-hmm.
And she's not reckless attacking.
Okay.
So hits. And then there's no point. Yeah, she's gonna go ahead and reckless attack because there's no point. Okay. So first one hits you, and then we're gonna go and do the rest on Laguna.
What the fuck? Laguna is untouchable. Does this guy have plot armor?
Dude, I don't know, man. And I'm literally just rolling these dice. All right, so Ox are taken. That's crazy, man. Like, it's going back and forth. No one's hitting, like, him and her are not hitting each other. It's like they're like, in on it.
It's because he's in love with her. That's what's going on.
That's fucking terrible.
It's the beginning of Laguna's love story.
Oh, man.
Can't wait before he gets a deck of magic cards and he accidentally kills her.
I'm tired of you bringing up my pain, all right?
All right, so I actually take 11 points of slashing damage. Normal, all right, so.
Is it magical?
No, it's normal.
Okie dokie. So that's there. Six.
Mm-hmm, yep. All right, and then... Miss Essen over here. By the way, Sterling and Ox, you actually see over here, there's a chest, but slumped over on the chest is a heavily mutilated body of Brave Whisper, the RSA agent that was working with you guys or was allied with you for a moment. So she, to both the Ox and Sterling, like you heard from Godolina, like he was gone for like a week. I couldn't contact him, and there he is over there. His armor and his little nice dagger have been taken off and are also resting on top of his chest. But anyways, that's none of your concern because this one's gonna stab you, Sterling.
Now that I've expressed what's happening, you're gonna get stabbed.
Now you see what you need to go get. Go ahead and die.
Yeah, go ahead and die right before it. All right, here you go. First attack hits.
Oh, good.
And then
definitely does.
There's two attacks, so the second attack misses.
At least hits. At least there's no.
It might not misses. I have misses. 16.
Okay, cool. So misses. Only one hits. Yeah, it's just normal. So here we go. 7 points of piercing damage. He will go ahead and cunning action. No, he's not going to cunning action. He's going to stay there. All right. That's it for the pirates, I think. So we're going to go to Lena, top of your order. Go to Lena is going to go ahead and disengage and then bonus action heal Sterling. Laguna's just like, you bitch. Sterling, you gain back 13 HP as this massive light lit glyph appears in front of her, heals your wounds. And the tri woman's just like, oh, interesting. You need to die then. Okay. Heal, that wasn't really an action, so she can't do much. So, Steven or Sterling, what are you guys doing?
I can go first on this one.
Yeah, you do that.
I will. It's kind of an unfortunate spot, so I'll take out my short sword and I'll start attacking with that.
We're gonna first attack.
Ooh, that's an 8 on the first one and a 21 on the second.
Okay, so before you do go ahead and make your attack, but she will use your reaction to riposte on that failed attack, so she will make a free a melee attack as a reaction.
Damn it.
Do yours first though.
Second one hits, so it's a 4 damage.
4 damage. Yeah, she'll take it. And she is actually caught off guard that you actually caught her. She's like, huh, all right, on guard. And then boom, here we go. So stabby stab under dirty 20. For 7. 7 points of piercing. I think. All right.
I will. I think I'm going to. God, this is very crowded. This hallway.
Yeah.
Does it look like our items are in that room? Like.
You see some treasure over here, but other than that, you don't really see anything that looks like your stuff or even Tav's stuff for that matter. You do see a chest, but you don't know what's inside it.
Yeah. I will take my bonus action to. I'll just second wind to regain some health. And I think that's all I can really. Oh, you know what? I'll move around and bind her with my movement. And that's it for my turn.
Steven.
Move here. It's going to heal a little bit. Then it's going to. Did she reckless or is it just straight?
Oh. It's reckless. She reckless.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, so let's see here. 14?
14 does not hit.
Okay. Then there's even worse. And nat 20. So that's 9 damage only.
9 damage. He is still alive with just a few pieces of HP left.
Oh. And that's it for Steven.
All right. Wow.
Finish her off.
Laguna. If Laguna doesn't do this, though, I'm going to be very, very annoyed. It might kill him off. So Laguna, with his first attack, as he sees her just barely hog, he's like, oh, this is it. It's not the way I want it. But hell, I'm not going to kill you first. He looks at you. I was like, witness me.
I hope he misses. I sincerely hope he misses. Because if he misses and I hit, I'm going to be like, bam.
That one hit. So that should this should probably do it. And it does. So Laguna will get the final kill on Vapu. And as he points to you, just continues to stare at you and just right through the dead center of her skull, her cranium. She slumps to her knees and falls over, and then looks down at the corpse and says, I could have handled myself. And she's dead.
I just look at him like, you're an idiot.
But he's no longer raging. Well, he actually is still raging. Because he killed somebody. All right. He's going to go ahead and move. Second attack on this poor son of a bitch. He was like, sand? Sand will help, sand.
Fuck sand.
We'll go ahead and roll the hit, but he will go ahead and obviously dirty fighting.
That's a reaction, right?
Yeah.
Perfect.
he's using against Laguna, yeah. But I don't know if Laguna still makes it out of this, he might die anyway. So, here we go. Oh, man, throw away. Nice. So dexterity saving throw. Gosh, darling. All right. Dex. Okay. Passes nat 20. he literally just wipes the sand in midair away, and the guy's just like, oh, I fucked up.
Wait, it says him, Wimus, bitch. We swim through that. We swim to the sand.
Swim through sand. Sand is on the fuck. All right, so let's go, Ox. We're done.
Chaos rising.
Chaos rising.
Did he manage to hit him?
So he does hit him and he does kill him. Sorry.
Okay.
And he just right through the skull, dead.
Huh. And so I just look at that. I look at the one in front of me, like, eh. And I'm just going to saunter on over here and just walk over. Bonus action. We're going to go ahead and put the tentacles right here. So tentacles are going to try to hit first. That is a 19 to hit.
Yeah.
That 3 cold damage.
Cold damage.
Reduced by 10. And then, since I am flanking, I will have advantage with my buzzing greatsword, and I'm going to use booming blade.
You're activating your buzzing greatsword now?
No. Not at all.
You're just using the sword. Okay.
Yep. That is a 23 to hit.
Definitely, yeah.
That is 8 magical slashing and 5 thunder.
Ready.
And after that, after the thunder dissipates, I'm like, let's take this one alive. Yeah. And that is my turn.
All right. Miss Edison's like, we'll see about that. And she will go ahead and lay down strikes all on Sterling.
Why me?
I gotta look up my ability here real quick. I think I can use my reaction when she attacks an ally and she's within 5 feet of me that I can use Sentinel.
Are you talking about Sentinel?
Yeah.
Okay. Why? So she missed the first time, but she hits the second time.
Okay. That is a 25 to hit her as she hits the second time.
Yes.
7 magical damage.
That's 7 magical damage. And then Sterling, you're going to go ahead and take 10 points of piercing damage. All right. She will attempt to disengage. So you both have it. And then you obviously have Sentinel.
Yeah. Well, I just use Sentinel as my reaction, so I can't do anything.
Oh, you used it for that instead. Okay, so so Sterling, you have an attack of opportunity. And then Godelina as well. Well, depending if you go that way.
Boy, 10.
10, no. Okay, cool. So she'll go ahead. She'll actually go ahead and move this way. And how much movement do I have? 10 feet left. You know what, dude? She's gonna just jump out the window. Jumping out the window. Boom. All right. Go to Lane's turn. Go to Lane's gonna rush over 30 feet, and she's had to spend her action to dodge, or not dodge, to dash, and she gets to the window. So, Steven Stern, what are you guys doing?
I will run up to the window as well. 25 feet. How far down is it?
So you look down, you guys are at the very top, so it's around 60 feet or about 50 feet. She is currently 5 feet below you and 5 feet out.
Boy, it's like a bad idea. But I might survive. I want to jump out after.
Okay. I'm glad that he's not the only one.
Yeah. So what do you plan on doing?
I just want to jump. I want to try like attack her as she's falling.
Oh god.
Yeah. All right. Sounds good. So as you jump off, go ahead and make a athletics check.
All right.
Opposed athletics. So it's like a grapple. So
yeah, 12.
Grapple. 12. All right, what's she roll? She has nothing. All right, so here we go. This is the base. Wow! So you fly out, and she's like flying. She just... From her peripheral, she's like, are you kidding me? And you just boom, from above, just bear hug her, and you just fly further down towards the sandy rocks below, as this the beach in front of you all right now. Okay, so you are now 10 feet below the window, falling, Sterling. Golan is just like
he's probably thinking, I expected this from Ox, but not Sterling.
Not Sterling, yeah. Death changes people. So, Steven, what are you doing?
Run over to Tab and see if she's still alive.
Yeah, Sterling approaches Tab. Sterling checks. Steven. Steven approaches Tab and checks. There's no life, there's no vials. And Steven is filled with remorse and begins to cry. And he begins to hold and pick up Tav's stabbed to shit body. there's so many stab wounds from the rapier.
Maybe you shouldn't have been the one that killed the bear.
All right, so it's okay. One of many, I'm sure, will come. One of many mistakes. We'll just see how far that lasts. So whose turn is it?
Well, it was Stevens, but he's going to do that.
Laguna's not going to do anything because he's like, it's done. He'll start perusing them. Well, actually, he's going to look over here. He's like, he's going to listen. He's like, there's a lot of people moving downstairs. I'm going to check it out.
Oh, God. I mean, that's on him. If he dies down there, I don't care.
All right, so he goes down there. Ox, what are you doing?
I'm going to dash to the window to see effectively if Sterling managed to grab the person, and I see that he has, so I'm just like, user is an airbag. And then I'm just gonna move around and start looking through treasure.
Well, it's like, you're all so unbelievable. All right, pirates. There's no pirates. Well, she's gonna attempt to break free from your grapple, Ox or Sterling. So opposed grapple. So opposed life. She will four. That's probably not gonna do it.
Athletics again.
Yeah.
Another 12.
That's all. Okay. And then Godolina is gonna go ahead and use her remaining time on her fly, her radiant soul, to produce her wings and fly and pick up both of you.
Oh.
And it's going to fly you to the roof. Well, she's going to grab onto you, and she's like, Sterling, what was the plan going forward? Were you just going to drop with her? And then what else? You probably both may have survived.
Well, the plan was if I survived, I was going to knock her out and then, you know, take her somewhere and then interrogate. It's okay. Very loose. I didn't want to... We lost Tab, and there's no one else here to interrogate, and we need to know some things.
Sure.
I don't have rope. Do you have any?
Well, yeah, she's like, don't worry, we'll figure this out. So she flies all of you back. She actually, you're probably hanging like just like Miss Edidin's probably like hanging lower than you. So Godolina's gonna fly and just bonk her head against the wall.
Wham! Thunk.
Just knock her out. And then that's gonna do that. So you both are now back in the room with an unconscious Miss Edidin. But Ox, you're gonna look around?
Yeah, I'm searching through treasure. I'm also, once we get everyone inside the room, including Tav and Steven, I'm going to shut the door. So that, you know, in case anybody decides to come up through there, we at least have some warning of a door opening.
Well, Laguna comes up and says, yeah, they're pretty much, like, leaving. Like, they're grabbing all their gold down there, because that's where the vault's down there. All their ledgers. So they're all just packing up. So I don't think they're going to be coming up here, because they heard fighting. So I think we're good.
All right. So, yeah, I'm going to look for loot. I'm going to use magical awareness.
What are you doing, Sterling, and everyone else? Or Sterling, what are you doing?
I want to try to find my stuff.
All right, where do you want to look?
I guess I'm next to the treasure chest. I'll look through that.
So as you open the treasure chest and Ox, as you are looking around with your magical awareness, you sense that there's a couple of magical items in that chest, along with the armor of, like, what looks like to be black owl feathers of armor, and then a dagger that looks like it's made out of, like, glass, like dark glass. But Sterling, you're right there, so you actually have those two in your hand now, because they're on top of the chest. So I guess there you go. And then you open the chest. And Gordon's like, all right, can we hurry this up and leave? We probably get out of here and then figure out how.
I need my stuff. You don't understand. All I have is my musket right now.
And so you want to continue to fight?
I've lost a lot of things.
I'm going to take Tav then and head back to the Raiden Keep. You can do whatever you want.
All right, I'll probably just like jump out the window again if I have to.
Okay.
I'm not gonna, dude,
if people were coming back,
if you want, yeah, okay, so I'll go ahead and give you what you find in this room, and then I'll let you figure out if you guys want to stay. If you want to stay, then we're going to sort this out. You both are searching, I'm assuming.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
So searching through, Ox, you find 1,000 gold pieces, 200 silver. Sterling, you find 2,000 gold pieces, 1,000 silver. And you find a pouch of gemstones. Looks like to be, you know, pretty nice gemstones. You don't know how much it costs or how much it retails for. You have that. Ox, you find a ring of protection. You know what it is.
Yep.
Along with two potions of climbing, and then Sterling, you find a potion of acid resistance. And you also come across two magical items from what looks like to be the gear of Braided Whisper, this owl looking armor, and this glass dagger.
Okay.
All right.
I'll take that. And then can I pick up Brave Whisper's body?
You can, yeah. It's heavily mutilated, like flesh has been flayed and stuff.
This was someone Gotolina knew, right?
It was a contact that Gotolina met, but they're not close.
Okay. So is she doing? Okay. I'll just leave him there then.
Yep. All right. So what are you guys going to do? There are some movements downstairs, but you can hear there are still a lot of people downstairs, and eventually someone or some people may come up to see how everything's going up here. Saman and Katja are missing. They were here, so who knows? Gotolina's already flown out with Tav and Steven, so it's just you, Laguna, who's about to jump out soon. He's about to go up to the roof again and use the rope to climb.
Yeah, run back to the rope and just leave that way.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. I still have all my stuff, so... You'll have to convince me to stay.
I paid like 2,500 gold for that one sword to get repaired. I haven't got to use it yet.
Maybe we can. So in order to keep Sterling from going crazy and doing this,
there's a 30 seconds to decide.
I just like so. Why don't we just hire the Thieves Guild to locate your stuff, and we'll get it back when it's safer and we've had more rest because it's been a crazy day.
I guess you're right.
Okay, let's get the hell out of here. And I start running towards the roof to get on the rope and get out.
Sterling, are you following or are you going to stay?
I'll follow. I don't want to to risk it that much without anyone helping me.
Okay. So you make your way back onto the roof and use the rope to get across. I do need everyone to make climbing checks with advantage. Well, Ox, are you going to bamf over there real quick?
Well, no. I mean, if it's 50 feet, we can just go down the side of the building. I have 50 feet of climbing rope, so.
Oh, yeah, that's fine.
Yep. So I'm just going to go down the side of the building rather than like across and do all this other crazy stuff. Because sure. I can't bamf anymore. I'd need a short rest.
Okay. So eventually, after about 10 minutes, you guys all are finally at the grounds. None of the guards are there, obviously. It seems that Sterling's and Tav's pupils have been successful. So where are you guys heading now?
So I just look at Sterling, I'm like, it costs like 3,000 to like resurrect you. I think we should probably, I assume that Gardelina is going back into the temple.
Yeah.
So let's go
head there with what we got from here.
So yeah, I guess we're heading to the Radiant Keep.
Look, you make your way back to the Radiant Keep where Gardelina is already there. The only one who's not invited is Laguna, who has to sit outside as Dame Harav is out there watching him. And you know, Laguna's like always like antagonizing, like, come on, let's fight, let's go, come on.
As I walk by, I'm just gonna whisper in Dame Harav's ear, he thinks you're cute. I just keep walking.
He says some very foul things after you leave, like, and she's just like, oh yeah, he definitely likes me. As you make your way back to that same room, High Priest Kamos, which I don't think I showed you a picture of, he's a very gaunt man, he's wearing a very noble priestly attire, and this is what he looks like, sort of reference, I guess. He does have a very nice white staff with a holy icon above. As you return, Gardelina is like pleading to Kamos, like, please. She's like, first of all, Gardelina, I am still tired from literally an hour ago of bringing your friend back. It's going to take me at least a couple of days to rest. Furthermore, do you even have the money or a diamond that's worth 3 grand or 3,000 gold pieces?
I'm guessing we walk in at that point.
Exactly. You walk in at that exact point.
I'm going to guess me and Sterling just hold out pouches of gold.
How much do you guys have?
We have, I think together we have at least 3,000 gold.
Yeah.
So right, I have 1,000.
You're going to give 1,000, and what is Sterling giving?
2,000, I think, that's what I got, right?
Yep. Yeah.
Hey! Okay, so you give it to Kamos, and Kamos like, give me, by the end of the night, I will begin the ritual once again, but I need some rest. And Gardelina is just like, look, that's all we're going to get. It's the best we can get. You know, you're doing us a huge favor, High Priest. And Kamos is like, oh, I know. I've been doing a lot of favors in the city for quite some time now. As he gets up, I hear the cracking in his bones, his back, as he takes the gold and summons the servant, like, go buy a diamond at the bazaar.
You reminds me of someone really humble.
I was not going to say it. I was just like, this guy seems familiar.
Like, hold up. How is he anything close to Morjor?
I mean,
I honestly don't see.
No, it was like, it was the one comment. It was the whole thing of like, yeah, I've been doing a lot of favors.
I've been doing a lot.
That sarcasm. It was very reminiscent of Molshiad.
Yeah, it's I guess. Now it's just spanning to strangers that you barely know that you're just going to. You're gonna label them as such,
you guys, if you're sarcastic. Truly...
No, it's more like borderline cynical at this point. Honestly. So you have the rest of the day. What do you guys want to do? Well, you two, until Tad goes back, which almost likely Tad will be back next session. We'll get into that.
Okay, I assume Sterling, you want to go hire the thieves to try to track down your equipment.
Yeah, I'll probably do that. And also want to look into the items I got of Brave Whisper.
Are you guys heading back to your home or are you going to stay here? Laguna's hanging back to the Artisan's Guild Hall because he's pissed.
I'm gonna spend some time here to look at the items and obviously attune to the ring. But then I'll probably go to the Artisan's Guild Hall too.
While you're doing that, Sterling, where are you going to be?
I go to the a Thief's Guild to hire someone to like, look for my stuff, if I can do that. And then I go back to the home and investigate the items I have.
Okay. So you can go back to Secret Cloud, the Tabaxi woman that you've been going to so far. She can look into it. So that's a hard bargain. She's already heard rumors that the Good Circle has already been disbanding a lot of their like activities here in the city. She can go ahead and try to spare, but she's going to have to take away some of the security over your home to do so. So it's going to be like 3 or 4 thugs guarding your home, watching your home, instead of the normal like 12.
I'm going to tell Sterling where I am so that if he needs anything.
And I guess, how much is she asking for the job?
She's going to charge 20 gold, but like I said, she's not confident in finding every piece of thing that was stolen from you. So
I just want the main things, like my magical items, mostly.
So you can give her a description, but that's the best she's going to do. Yeah. That's all she's going off of.
Yeah, I just give her a description of my lions, my short sword, and my dagger, specifically. And then I guess I describe the specific people who I know were there, like the spymaster and all of them.
Right.
Yeah, that's all I can really do. Yeah, that's what I'll do, I think.
Okay. Secret Cloud takes that. She says, "All right, well, I'll try to get what I can for you. I'll try to get back to you in a couple weeks or two if I can't make any promises, and it's going to take that long to me even just get people around the city, and hopefully most of them haven't left yet." So with that, you return home, you go ahead, probably attune to those, or you want to study those items. Everyone go ahead and take a long rest as well, since you're at it. All right, so the leather armor, the black owl leather armor, is called Owlhide armor, I think it's called, and then the dagger is called the Shadow Glass Dagger.
Whoa.
For once, my AC is over 14.
Can fucking fly.
Later that night, High Priest Kamos will go ahead and perform the ritual. None of you, I'm assuming all of you will go back to who's remaining back at the home with Jeffrey?
Well, if no one else will, then I will stay there just to make sure that no one comes in and tries to grab.
Well, you have those pupils. That's what I'm saying. You have all those pupils. Are you gonna like you can use them stuff?
I have my three. Keep watch and hang around Jeffrey. Just make sure he's okay.
Okay.
I will. I'm gonna go ahead and. I assume that Tavs want to go be with her, so I'm gonna send them, and I will stay in their place.
So you and
Sterling's henchmen,
Sterling's boys. Yeah, okay. Sounds good. All right. So Sterling, you return back to Raiding Key with Godelina, and you witness the resurrection of Tav. It is use of very powerful divine magic, something that you're not accustomed to. And you can see just how potent the influences of some of these greater divine deities can be, as Tav is slowly returned to life. But we will go ahead and we'll go ahead and cut today's session short, and we will pick things up next Saturday.
Woo! Woo! At least we're not all dead again. Kind of.
Well, we have all done our contract.
Thanks everybody for joining us. We'll be back next Friday for the Red Opera, assuming you know everything goes well, where everyone gets to figure out what the hell Invars is doing. And then obviously next Saturday we'll be back with another City of Illumination. Thank you everybody, and have a wonderful rest of the day.
Bye.